The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Just when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in.
The biggest, most outrageous online show in Philippine history.
20 million fucking downloads.
Interactive in 35 countries. Mo is back with a vengeance in Season 2. Bigger, better, badder.
Let's start off with an international call. Yesterday we took a call from India. Tonight it's Canada.
Nice.
Let's go to Ireland. Where in Ireland are you?
Well, I'm in Dublin.
Some people say that I'm a bad guy. They may be right.
Let's go to Afghanistan. Holy shit, are you fucking really in Afghanistan?
Yeah, man, what's up?
Florida.
What's up?
I just found your show today, and I think it's great.
Live from Hollywood and at the Beyond the Box Studios in One Rockwell, Makati, it's Good Times with Mo, the podcast, Season 2, the Bigger, Better, Badder podcast. Your questions about love, life, sex,
and more sex
are all answered and occasionally made fun of here. And now the man who loves women and dudes, but not in the same way, the Philippine genius, DJ Mo Twister.
All right, here we go. Let's do it again on this Monday evening or morning or whatever fucking day it is you're listening to Good Times with Mo, the podcast, as we kick off another week, another episode. Welcome to the show. My name is Mo. That there is Dr. Ken. And I'm pretty excited about tonight because we have one of our regulars, meaning one of our friends of the show that comes by every now and then, does a really good job, gets a lot of downloads, a lot of hits. It's probably because she's super funny, super hot, super smart, does all these really great things, is charming and all that. So we haven't seen her on the show in a while because we took that really long break, but it's nice to have her back. And I'm sure, hopefully, if she isn't too busy, we're going to hear from her a lot this season. First, though, Dr. Ken, how are you? Hope you had a good day and a good weekend.
Yes, I did. I did have a good weekend, and I'm ready tonight.
Daiana Menezes is super foxy, isn't she?
She is very stunning, Mo.
She's really good looking, man. And she's Maganda. Super sexy. I mean,
yes, yeah. Very nice.
I've always said this. Best butt I've seen, at least amongst my friends. You know? Like you'll see like my A-list celebrities in Hollywood. And, you know, yeah, stand up, turn around. Yeah, I see a lot of Hollywood stars like in New York and L.A. So I see it like, wow, shit, thing to me, katawan, you know? But when I'm in the Philippines, no better butt than Daiana Menezes. And I'm not saying, Daiana, that's all you have. I mean, shit, face, pow, everything,
oh,
bam.
No.
I mean, it's everywhere. But it's just an exceptional butt. Good. Thanks for being here. Good evening, Daiana Menezes. Ang pangbansang amiga. That's right.
And good morning.
How are you?
Sa'yo, no? It's morning for you. So
yeah, it is morning.
I wish
here,
you could see us. Like, you know.
I wish I could see you.
You didn't see what I just did now. Like, I just gave you a butt show.
I'm not sure if I've asked you this before, so please forgive me, listeners, if you're big fans of the show and you've heard me say this, but is the butt thing, that's a Brazilian thing, right? I mean,
yeah.
Everybody in Brazil has ass.
Yeah, well, everybody has ass everywhere.
No, but you know, I'm talking about real ass, you know, not this flat.
Well,
you know,
just like what I said, I don't want to just create any, like, intrigues again, because the last time I was here and I said I had a real butt and somebody else didn't. It created a big, big fuss. And
you said that?
Do you remember?
I don't even remember.
I was kind of hurt because the person I was with by the time, and we just recently broke up by then, was dating somebody who didn't have a real butt. So we were talking about the butt of that person. And then for some reason...
Was this Maui Taylor? This is Maui Taylor.
Oh my God, don't even mention any names.
Not according to my name. They can always check it out.
I don't know, dude. I've never touched her butt, so I have no idea.
Okay.
But
I
can check it out. I don't know. I think you did, right?
That what? That you said? I haven't touched her butt.
Well,
no, I mean... She was my radio partner, so I didn't. Hey, I don't sleep with all my radio partners. All right. Anyway, welcome to the show. Phone number 478-7954. If you want to call us, get yourself on the program. Again, Daiana Menezes is here to answer your questions. You can catch us on Skype. We have some Skype calls ready to go, especially from abroad. It's the Good Times Podcast on Skype if you want to get in touch with us there. A lot of things have happened, Daiana, in your life since I've seen you, which we'll talk about in a little bit. Not too in depth because, you know, all of this, all of the calls coming in is basically people and their problems and questions they have. But every now and then we'll throw a question into our celebrity. So Daiana is here. You can follow her on Twitter. Now, the Twitter thing, and I follow you on Instagram, and I'm really always happy to see you there because, again, you know, sometimes you'll show that outstanding butt of yours. And listen, because you and I are friends. Like, we're kind of like brother-sister kind of friends. Like, you know, we'll mess around and joke around. Yeah. But but you're kind of like my sister that I can say is super incredibly hot that I wouldn't mind seeing in a bikini. You know, like, I can't really say that to my sister or my sister-like friends. Like, oh, magsuot ka naman ng bikini. But with Daiana, even though we're kind of like sister-brother in our relationship, or at least our friendship, we're that kind of level. But every time you do a bikini photo, I'm like, yeah, look at that. Yeah.
I would always pose, right? If not,
yeah, double tap on Instagram, like, very like.
That's right. So, I hope it's not just like about the body, right?
No. I'm just.
I give.
No, just I don't get to. Yeah. I don't get to talk to you. So when I see you, it's always through, you know, through Twitter or Instagram. So
I know.
Yeah,
that's true.
But a lot of it is the body too.
You know, we miss you so much here. I was telling you, kanina, diba? So
yeah, thank you.
When I was texting people, I was like, what? He's not there? I'm like, what?
I can't
believe that. What the hell? I want to see Mo. But it's okay. At least now we are talking. So.
Yeah, that's true. And your lovely accent and all that. Oh, shit. You're just amazing. All right, let's get to this. Let's get to these calls. Let's start with Benjamin, who is on line one. He is from Las Piñas. He's only 18 years old, and he's got a question for all of us. Dr. Ken, of course, again here. And we will try to knock these calls out. Benjamin, welcome to the program. How are you?
Hi.
And you're 18.
Hi, I'm fine. Hi, Daiana.
What's up?
And hi, Digimo.
What's going on? Benjamin.
Yes.
Why are first callers never paying attention? Benjamin, what's your question? Let's go.
So my question is, where and what is the best time to do it and why?
Where and what kind of question is this? I mean, like, you jump, especially at your age, you do it at every opportunity. And what do you mean, why? Like, what are you talking about here? I thought you had a legit question. Like, you had a specific question.
Yes, it's because, like, this is my third time to have a girlfriend. And I'm really nervous because my past two girlfriends, when we're going to do it, they always say that it's not the right time, it's not the right place. So, I really want this moment to be perfect.
They have a baby.
Benjamin, they're talking. Yeah, they're talking. Yeah, and whatever animal that is in the background.
It's a cat.
Is that a cat? Yeah, it's dying,
yeah.
Benjamin. Please, bring it to the vet. Bring it to the vet at the end of this fucking call.
Okay.
When a girl says it's not the right time and not the right place, I don't think she literally means the time of the day and the place that she's currently in. She's saying she's not ready to have sex. And that's because she's probably 16 or she's probably 15 and she's not ready. So when they go, this is
not into him.
She's the first one is actually older than me. Yeah.
Okay. Well, how old were you at the time? You were like what, 16? Yes, I'm assuming the first time.
Actually, the first time I did it was when I was 14.
14. Okay. You see, even though she's older. Even though she's older, what is she, 15? I mean, you get what I mean? Like, you're not going to find a lot of girls at that age range, 15 to 18, that's ready to have sex at any given time. You know what I mean?
She's,
and when they
she's
say...
actually 18, that's fine.
Okay, whatever. Benjamin, whatever. Still, you hear the word teen at the end of that kind of explains it all. They're not ready yet. And when they say it's not time, it's not the right place, they don't literally mean the exact hour on the clock. It means... it's not the right time for me. This is not the right place for me to do this. I mean, I'm not in the right place mentally. It's not the right time emotionally. That's what it means. Now, if you have a girlfriend now that's willing to do it right now, then that means she's in the right time and she's in the right place in her life to do it. Not literally.
Because I was actually talking to her. We talked about it. That we are gonna do it, but she's like scared that what if it doesn't turn out right? What if it's not like what, I mean, it's not the right yeah. place. She says those kind yeah. of things my past girlfriend says. But
that means that she's not ready. Yeah, she well,
how
listen,
old is
she
a girl? I'm sorry. But
she's actually, I'm 18 now, and she's actually a little bit older than me. She's 20.
She can't say, I'm sorry, as a girl, I will just tell you my opinion, but whenever I want to do it, I will do it, even if it's in the elevator and there's no age and no place. You know, like, I've even done it in my parents' bedroom and there's nothing wrong with it.
I mean, Diana, but do you remember that time, and I don't know if this applied to you, do you remember that time when you first were going to do it or the first times you were about to try to do it?
Do you know how I lost my virginity? That's very...
No, you never said it. Well, please.
Wow, first time. I said that's the first time I'm going to open this up. It was in a car.
Oh, inside the car. How unfortunate.
Really? No, it was great. Right. And then the next day I was like, did it really happen to me? Or like, because of course, you don't just lose your virginity out of nowhere. You keep on like, you know, you have your plays and everything. You keep on playing and doing because you're not a pro. So
right.
when the thing really happened, I was still wondering if that was it. Because you don't really know what's going on. So I wouldn't tell my boyfriend, no, it's not right. That's not the right place. It's how you're feeling. It's how... Sorry for the word, but how malibog you are for your partner, right?
No, I agree. And Diana, those are all good points. But you have to, like you said, you're not a pro yet. So your mind is still spinning. Like, ikaw, by the next day, you're like, was that it? I mean, that's supposed to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There are questions in there. So sometimes what happens is, hot na hot ka, malibog ka, but the moment it's about to happen, dun ka nang back out, oh my God, okay, I'm not ready yet. You know, it's to get to that first point where you're gonna really do it. Sometimes, yeah, your mind is there already, tapos gagawin mo, hindi naman gumagana, kasi ibang butas pinasukan, you know, I mean, there's all of these weird kind of things that can happen at that first. That's why the first time is always the worst time. And I'm so jealous that Diana's first time was great. Even though you're like, oh, it's great.
Because there was no blood at all, you know. Like, sometimes there's a bleeding or something. So what I did was I went to the doctor and then I had it checked. The doctor said,
really?
Yeah. And then they said, okay. Yeah, you're no longer a virgin. I'm like, I'm happy.
Like, great. Good for you.
And I kept on doing it and now I know how to do it, you know.
Yeah, now you're a pro. That's right.
Oh,
that's
I'm not bigger. Sure. That we have to ask my partners.
All right. Benjamin, listen, in my opinion, it's more a state of mind that they're talking about than an actual time and place. However, and not to take anything away from Diana and her experience, try not in a car. Yeah, try you know, in a nice place.
Yeah.
You know, shit like that. All right?
The best test.
Maybe it's because the first time I did it when I was 14 was in the school bathroom.
Yeah, let's go ahead and level up from school bathroom and even car. And let's go with a bed, some sort of like room that you're familiar with. Remove yourself from the motel kind of place and get a little bit better scenario going. Now Ken, why don't we all say how we lost our virginity? Because kawawa naman si Diana at si Benjamin dito, sila lang nagsasabi, no? Ken, how old, where, I mean, what happened?
Oh my God.
Patay ako sa asawa ko kasi asawa ko siya. No, okay, I'll tell. Where? College na yata yun eh. College na yun. Oo. Tama, marunig ako. Importanteng tao yung father-in-law ko.
At their house?
No, bro. In our house.
It's better than the bathroom.
Oh, that's true. But I think this guy is asking for a particular set of skills.
Yeah, I think so, right? Too. It's not about the place.
What is this, Taken the movie?
I know.
A particular set of skills that if you fuck me out.
Like, tsagain niya lang. Kasi bro, yung caller natin, I'm sure your girlfriend is very anxious. And like what Mo said, pag malapit ka na, dun siya mag-hesitate eh. So, ano ka lang, tsagayin mo, try this time, and then prepare for it, make the mood better, and then pag bigla siyang umayaw.
Is it gonna be Benjamin's first time with this girl?
I guess.
No,
that's a good question.
It's actually my third time.
Okay, when you had...
No, with this girl though.
Yeah, with this girl, the same person, right?
No, it's not the same person.
Oh, so it's your first time with the girl who's like... giving you a hard time of the place on where and when having
it,
right?
First was when I was 14, then 16, then 18.
Okay, oh, so maybe she's just not into having sex with you. It's just as easy as that.
Yeah, right now. Listen, Benjamin, it's just right now. Trust me. You, like Ken was saying, it's going to, you know, you just keep trying. But the thing is, you know what's going to make it successful? And this is kind of bad for us to say, because if she's not ready, she's not ready. But, you know, to get her a little bit more ready, have her really enjoy the night. Have her really enjoy being around
you.
You know, not, because the thing is, you guys are talking and you're going, so yeah, let's have sex. Let's finally have sex on Saturday. But you guys are scheduling it.
Exactly.
Get away from that shit. Just kind of go out, have a lot of fun that day, really be romantic, take her to nice places, and you'll find out that she's a little bit more ready than she was nung tineks mo lang siya. Oh no, magsisex na ba tayo Saturday?
Benjamin. You know what? You have the same name as my fiance, and like, we never planned anything. And I gave him a hard time to have his first time with me, and
he gave you a hard time.
Well, right. Also, of course, he had to be hard, right. Or else. What else?
All right, Benjamin. Thanks.
It wouldn't work.
Thanks for the call, man. We appreciate it. Have a good day, sir.
Thank you.
Good call. First one off. Okay, Ken, you're evading the question here, buddy. Before we get to the next where was it?
It's in our house. So we were a bit young then, and syempre, iba noon, iba ngayon. That was a long time ago, and culture then was different from what's now. Hindi man sobrang lolo na ako, pero yeah, you have to hide.
You're still young.
Diba? You have to hide, you have to sneak.
I was doing it at my roommate's bed. He was, kasi yung bed niya king size bed or queen size. Yung sa akin lang mga single lang. No. This is not that roommate. This is prior. This is long. This is like 15 years old. Mm-hmm. And I was... it's funny because yung window niya yung nasa harap ng bahay, so or yung parang townhouse, so while doing it nakatingin kami sa bintana kung babalik siya, so we're looking down and see if he's walking back while we were doing it, and it was a very stupid and bad experience.
Sa America ba to? Sa America?
No, this was in Pasig.
Okay.
We were looking out the window to see if he's actually gonna arrive before I arrive in this girl. All right.
That's
anyway, 631. That's the radio show. 478-7954. Let's go to Dubai and talk to our first international caller of the night. Hold on, I just got to get the name here. I think this is Charlene. She's 25 in Dubai. Charlene on Skype. How are you? Diana Menezes is here, and Dr. Ken. What's up?
Yeah. Hi. Good evening, Mo. Good evening, hi. Diana and Dr. Ken.
Hi.
Yeah, I just like to get over with my psycho ex, because we were together for 7 months and we broke up like 2 months ago, but he keeps on stalking me in my social networking sites, sending me messages, showing up in my office randomly. And then worst part, when he like admitted to me that we had a sex tape that I wasn't aware that he had after all.
Wow. Okay, this is a interesting call. As often as we get Psycho X calls, this is tough, because he told you about the sex tape. Okay, yeah. Are there laws, because you're in Dubai, and you know, no offense to the Middle East, but we always kind of have these weird thinking that any kind of this wild sexual behavior is like punishable by hanging, you know? I mean, is there anything where it's like any, you know, sometimes they have weird laws there, or not weird, it's weird for us because we're a different culture, but are there laws there about videotaping sexual encounters, you know, all of these kind of things where you can approach the authorities and they'll go into his house and they'll just take things, you know, just grab shit? I want to know what the legal basis are for behavior like that.
Actually, I want to do it long time ago, but then I cannot just risk, because we're single, we're not married, and I cannot just tell the police that this is the case, because at the end of the day, I will be caught as well.
Exactly.
I'll get deported.
Because having sex before marriage is illegal also?
Yeah, it's illegal.
And she's on the tape, right? So...
Yeah, but she's on the tape and she doesn't know it, though.
Are you
So I'm thinking maybe there's some sort of like...
Yeah, I know that.
Maybe there's some sort of sex tape law in Dubai that's really like big time. Because I'm going to use this. Okay, he threatens you with a sex tape. You threaten him with death by stoning. Like, okay, yeah, release the sex tape. Do you know what the laws in Dubai are? They'll fucking stone you to death. So you pick. You get what I mean? You have to re-threaten him because the laws in that country are so stiff. Now all of a sudden, say he videotaped you in a sex tape in a country that doesn't care, then you're screwed. But because you're in Dubai and the laws are a little bit different in the Middle East, a little bit stricter, you can always re-threaten him. I dare you to release the sex tape. They will come after you and they will fucking hang you in the middle of downtown.
Yeah. The thing is, we had this situation. He was stalking me. I just saw him outside of the office, and then he keeps on following me. And then I told him, if you're gonna come near me, I'm gonna tell the police that I don't know you, and you keep stalking me. He's not threatened after all.
How did you find out about the tape, by the way? If it
was
just
stalking. He confessed it to me after we broke up. He told me that, okay, I don't have plans to tell you this, but then it looks like we're not gonna get back together. So I'm gonna tell you what happened. I mean, I'm gonna tell you one last thing that I need you to know.
Well, maybe he was just making up the
story.
Yeah,
maybe he's lying.
Have you seen it?
No. You guys, listen.
That was my idea. Crazy. But then when things
So you were aware. Wait. You just came up with this...
I think she said it was her idea that she was thinking. I think she meant she was thinking the guy was lying.
Okay.
But then when things got rough, he sent me a screenshot of the video. That was the worst.
My god, this guy is a piece of fucking art. This is this guy's fucking crazy.
Well, sorry, but that's kind of delicado. But we can talk about it, right? You had partners that you've done that before, and me too. I've taped myself, but I try as much as possible to delete right away because I'm aware of what I'm doing. But it never happened to me that somebody would tape me without me knowing. That's the tough part here. Yeah, exactly.
Okay, let's get to the problem. And yes, you're right, Dan. We've all videotaped ourselves having sex. I mean,
it's a fantasy, At the end of the day,
hold on, Charlene, one second. Hold on. Diane and I got to have some sexy talk here. Forget your problem right now.
From virginity now to sex tapes. What's going on here?
Forget your crazy boyfriend. Diana and I have a conversation to have a little bit.
Oh, my God.
Diana, when you got that body, man, you got to have to at least have it on tape one time. So when you go watch it back in the day, you're like, anything no more sexy. You got to really do that
shit.
What
messes up right now? This iCloud thing, because of the iCloud, sometimes from one
backup na.
Yeah, nagba-backup yung mga videos. So sabi ko, oh my god, paano to? Tapos buksan ko yung bagong iPad. Oh no! And I was in the States, I was opening what the hell? Why is this video here? You deleted that
Sam
long
YG.
Time ago. No, it wasn't him. No. Let's not put our friend here on the spot. No, it wasn't. But it's kind of embarrassing. But I was aware of it because I think it's everybody's fantasy. But at the end of the day, I think it gets into a point na if you find out that somebody taped you without you knowing, it's a crime.
Oh, absolutely.
And then now, I think she has to do something about it.
Yeah, Diana, by the way, before we get back to her, Diana, one thing.
Okay.
You think your boyfriend erased it? He didn't erase it. Trust me. Really. If there's a moment where you're going to have...
I'm the one taping Mo, not him.
Okay, but you better make sure you don't send him a copy. All right, let's get back to Charlene here. Charlene, all right, listen, you're in a whole lot of trouble. Let's go with how clear in the screenshot was your face?
It was it's far, and my face wasn't showing because the screenshot he sent me was I'm doing something to him.
Give him a blowjob.
Yeah.
Because here's the thing. I'm going to say most secretly taped sex tapes don't really come out very well. It's not very clear. For example, Diana, we'll go back to your experience. Remember, this is with a friend of mine, with Hayden, and Hayden's been on the show. Your friend
wasn't
was
my
in
my experience.
No. Your experience is okay. Your friend was in it. Your friend was in it, though.
Oh yeah, so, I had a friend who was in. Hayden's,
yeah, you had a friend who was in it. So that's what I meant. Your experience. Was it clear? I didn't. Was her? Did you know it was really her the moment you saw it?
Well, because nung pumutok yung balita, when everything exploded. People thought it was me, but since I clearly know whoever I have, you know, relationships with and whoever I have sex with. So, of course, I had to defend myself and say, no, no, hell no, it's not me. So once I checked it, and I was like, oh my God, it can only be this person. Kilala ko siya. Saka,
so namukhaan mo?
And she looks like she was like really doing a movie, dude. It looked really good. It looked good, and I admit. I mean, you know, kudos ako sa kanila. It was a very good tape.
Maka iCloud nga. All right. Anyway, so Charlene, my point here
see,
being
yeah,
is,
yeah, you can see the face. Yeah.
Yeah. My point here being is, there are when the hidden sex tapes are very difficult to identify who's involved in them. The reason why I'm telling you this is because I don't want you to be terrified. You should be scared. Yes. I don't want this guy to hold it against you so much. Like, have a power against you, you know, because of the sex tape. You have to just kind of go, listen, I'm not ashamed of what I've done. You know, having sex with you, yes, I regret it now because you're a psycho motherfucker. But if you taped us, that's fucking illegal. And you taped us in the jurisdiction of this country, which has extremely strict laws about this kind of behavior. I actually dare you to put that shit out on the internet. You'll be investigated, you will get arrested, and man, our punishment here in Dubai is fucking worse than any other country in the world. So, asshole crazy fucker, I dare you to do it. And if you don't stop stalking me and all of that stuff, I'm going to tell people what you have done. You really have to push back here, Charlene. Because what he's trying to do is he's trying to have these kind of he's looking for things to hold against you.
Yeah.
Like a leverage. That's right.
For you to stay in contact with him.
The thing is, I already told his mother.
Oh.
That's my next solution. I was going to say, go to the family. Even if it means admitting to the family that you indeed had sex with him, just go, Tita, you know, I cared strongly for him and all of that stuff. But do you know that he was taping us and all of these things? I mean, I wanted you to go to the family. Now, I'm hoping her family's not as crazy as he is. His family's not as crazy as he is. But what did the mom say?
She was sorry for it, and then what the mom did, he talked to his son, and then she said that if you're not gonna stop stalking her, then might as well come home here in the Philippines. But you know what he said? Yeah. He's really a psycho. He said that tang ina kung masisira yung buhay ko, edi sasama na kita.
Wow. Oh. Yeah, he's really trying to, yeah. Charlene, he's really trying to hold all this stuff against you. Listen, I would contact a lawyer. You know why?
Yeah, I was about to say that. It's as easy as getting a lawyer and, you know,
because with the
shit out of him.
Before you go to the police and you might get in trouble for having sex, I want you to talk to a lawyer and see what your options are legally. Because, you know, in other countries, lalapitin mo lang yung police. Oh, this guy called, you know, because sex is not illegal. I don't know if it's illegal. It's not illegal here where I'm at in the U.S. So if you're an adult, which you are, and you had sex, which you've done, it's fine. People do it. In Dubai, when you're not married and all that shit, yeah, fine. Different rules. That's why if I were you, I would contact. But man, I don't even know if telling the lawyer is safe because of the rules there, you know? What if you tell the lawyer, you know, I had sex, all of a sudden the lawyer's going to tell. See, it's so different with other countries. And I wish I could tell you the right advice, but there's such a legal aspect there. Yeah, that we don't know about. I would really, maybe go to a Filipino lawyer that works in Dubai and see your options there. Maybe go to the embassy, the Philippine embassy, because at least you're under the laws of the Philippines, which means any kind of admission regarding premarital sex in your home country embassy might not get you in trouble. There are little things there that you can do to hopefully not get put in jail while being the victim at the same time.
I just have another question. How's this?
Yeah.
He's telling me that maybe we can meet up or like this. I'm going to delete the video in front of you. Shall I believe him? Shall I?
No.
You know,
never believe that. Never, never.
Never. Didn't you just hear Diana's iCloud cuento? And the copies are made
easily.
Never
believe that. That doesn't exist.
Yeah, copies are made easily. Oh. He's manipulating you. Fuck this guy. Do you have a brother that can kill him or something like that?
My brother's in the
Philippines.
It's a problem.
All right. Just checking.
Scaring him is already good enough because he can't do anything. He can't do much. You're the victim. And anyways, you can just prove that you didn't know. You weren't aware that you were being taped. So
yeah,
he didn't do anything wrong. It's him.
And again, listen, if I were you, and this is starting to become a long call now. If I were you, I would contact the authorities about the stalking. And then just in case if he releases the sex tape, always have a backstory ready. I don't know, some kind of like, oh, we did this in the Philippines or we did this in another country. You know, again, these are things that you might want to sort out with a lawyer. But those are the excuses I would throw out just in case the police investigated me. All right.
Okay. Thank
Good
you
luck,
well.
Charlene. I'm sorry, man. Yeah. I hope he doesn't do anything. All right, bye-bye, baby. Tough call. Yeah. Tough one.
Yeah, it was really hard. But I think that was the best advice, Mo. Like, yeah. Seek a Filipino lawyer that would, like, you know, help you and not tell anybody. Because it's That's really right. different from their country.
Yeah,
very
and they
strict.
Have to yeah. analyze all the laws yeah, and everything.
It's really tough. All right, let's get to Paolo, who's 18. He's been on hold the longest. Line 3, Daiana Menezes is here. Dr. Ken, phone number 478-7954. You're listening to Good Times from the podcast season 2. Line 3, Paolo, 18 years old, Pasay. What's going on?
Hello.
Hey, Paolo.
Hey, what's up?
Hello.
Yes, Paolo.
Hi, Paolo.
Can you hear us?
Yeah.
What's going on?
I want to ask, like, I am in college right now. Then I told my girl best friend that I love her recently, but then I found out that he's in love with somebody else. Then, mm-hmm. just a while ago, she started texting me that she already answered his boyfriend, like, oh, sige, tayo na. Then I was like, are you out of your mind? I just told you I love it. Tapos magkukwento ko ng ganyang bagay. Parang, kasi dati tinanong ko, I've asked her na, I love you then. Parang may nangyari ba? Then sabi niya sa akin na, before, I love you, pero hindi ko sigurado kung if that was friendship or ano, mas malalim pa. Then,
hold on, time on, Paolo. Diana, how old are you now? How old are you
25.
Now? Ken, 36, right?
That's correct, Mo.
Yeah.
Remember these days? Remember yeah, when yeah, we were yeah, in like yeah. High school and yeah, teenagers yeah. and shit? Yeah. I love you, but I don't know because you're my friend. You're my friend. I love you. I don't know. But, you know, meaning I just I don't know. I'm not yeah. sure about loving you. It's like, it's you really, listening to this story, Paolo, makes me miss my childhood. I mean, and I think the advice kind of lies in my making fun of it is that look at us now. We're double your age, Paolo. At least Ken's double your age. I'm close to that. And all of these things, all of these kind of love confusing moments in school when you're in love with your best friend, and but they have a boyfriend, but you don't know kung MU ba talaga kayo o hindi. You know, it all kind of, it's all part of the growing up process. Now, I know that's horrible advice because it's not specific to your issue, but I just want you to know that no matter how confusing it gets and how wild and all of these things and feelings are all weird and hormones are all fucked up, that it all kind of settles down and you get into some sort of baseline main kind of like a consistent stream of the way you carry your love life and it all kind of evens out. I apologize for cutting you off in the middle of the story, but it is really fun to hear something like this because I remember when I was you and all fucking okay. crazy about, wait, does this girl like me or not? But she said she liked me, but putang ina, when I said I liked her, talking about my boyfriend, you know.
But it's in a phase that you guys also like, you start playing with everyone? Is that true? Like,
that's the guys that you've dated.
No.
You know,
no,
the problem
no, I mean,
with
like,
you,
no.
Diana.
Before.
No, Diana. Diana, I'll tell you what the answer is to that. Because you're a hot chick, Diana. You've always been attractive. So you attract all guys. Everybody likes Diana. Ken and I, look at us. Look at Ken. Look at I. Ken, sorry. I mean, you know.
No, yeah.
Not,
I understand what you mean.
Right?
Yeah.
So we don't have the chance to go up to the Diana Menezes of the world and look go, up. Hey, baby, what's up? No, really. I'll be honest. I'm an ugly kid. When I was young, I'm very short. No, listen, I've only become slightly attractive because I'm successful. But when I was in high school and college, I'm sure Ken medyo kahit papaano, you know, hindi
naintindihan ko.
Every now and then, we'll come across a girl that shows a little bit of interest in us. And when I say every now and then, this is like once in every 3 years, may girl who lalapitan ka. Parang, ano ba to? Parang may gusto yata sa akin. Why? First of all, why do you like me? What do I have? And then that's where the confusion starts coming in.
I ask that to myself. Now, why? Bakit ako?
Yeah, bakit ang pangit-pangit ko? Or I'm a nerd. What would you like me? And that's why we get into these issues, Paolo, because we're not supposed to be ladies' men. We're not built like the hunks who hang out with Diana and all of these hot chicks.
Ano ka ba? Hindi naman sila hunks, no? Actually, I'm not really into like guapo guys. It's more on their brain and, you know.
How come you didn't tell me that when we were friends? I would have dated you like that.
We wouldn't be friends if I told you that before.
Shit. Anyway, but you get what I mean, Paolo. It really is a very confusing part of your life at your age, especially the way you look. I'm going to say you're not a good-looking guy, and that's fine because neither am I. And no, really, because if you're a good-looking guy, chicks just come at you like a fucking, you know, gravity. It's just gravitational pull towards you. But when you're not, you really have to go through these moments of confusion and not knowing what to do. Anyway, what is your question? I'm sorry, all of that stuff gets back to what do you want to ask us?
Yeah, kasi anong gusto ang tanong. Para sinasabi niya sa akin, then before noon, before niya sabihin sa akin na sila, sinasabi niya na parang may something pa din siya. Ang ayaw lang niya kasi parang napitin ako. Parang, kasi I tend to be more close with girls.
You try to be more close to girls?
Ayaw sa kanya kasi ano.
Ay, pinabahan na yung phone kasi.
No, he got cut off.
Huli.
But I think if he's still listening, I think what even after what he said and all those things, may it may be real or not, ayaw sa kanya dahil lapitin siya sa girls. Bottom line, I think Mo gave a good advice that don't be too nearsighted. What you have as a kid is very important to you, whatever is close to your face. But what you should think about is look beyond that. Look ahead of that. And if you have you have to try, because it's really hard to do that when you're young. You see what's in front of you. You play it as it lies. But you gotta see. Like, you have to take a different path. But you'll also get there.
Yeah,
you'll also be successful. You'll also have a pretty wife.
Exactly. Yeah.
And all those things.
That's why I was like fair getting enough to the point that you guys also had that, you know, that time that you were medyo konyo, medyo, you know, you still don't want to court the girl. But then when you get the skills of doing it, then you start playing with them. Am I right?
Yeah, you're right. Diana, you're right, but you're right into a different kind, a different class of guys. Like, you're right to the... Really? Because you're saying, like, confidence, skills, playing with them.
You know
man,
why?
when Ken and I were in college, and I don't know Ken, but I'm assuming just the way we carry ourselves, when Ken and I were in college, there's no playing with girls. I mean, if we got a text message from a girl, we would keep it on our phone like you girls do. Like, oh yeah, because dude, we're not ma chicks. We're not lapitan ng chick. You know, when you're not
we're
that
like
kind
a
of guy,
geek or something. Like, you know.
Well, yeah. I mean, not a geek na Star Trek, Star Wars. Yeah. I wasn't that kind of geek. You know, like for example, I was accelerated in school 2 years, right? So when I was in college, I was 14, 15 years old. So all of my other classmates na magaganda, not only were they maganda and I'm not maganda, they're fucking 18 and I'm 15. They're never gonna say hi to me in my life. So my whole college years were spent really like not talking to a lot of people because I was extremely young and not very appealing. I don't have a car. I'm not tall. I'm not an athlete. Putang ina yung mga UAP guys na yan. Tangina, fuck. They're probably fucking in the fucking school.
You're from UP, doc.
No. Oh yeah, you're from UP. But you know what I mean? Like, it doesn't happen to guys like us.
Yeah,
and unfortunately, we don't have skills. We don't have any of these things. But look at us now. Big time
you know
radio
what?
Star.
That's what
huge number
us
one podcast in the country.
Yeah. And that's what makes us fall in love. You know why? Because we keep on like, at least me, like, I keep on thinking, like, why am I with this person? Like, what do they have? And then when I search that, just dig the history. For sure, they were a geek before, or they were like, you know, they're still like,
those are the ones
afraid.
You want.
Yeah, those are the ones I want. And it's one of the guy I'm marrying right now. Exactly, he's an example of it. Like, he was a geek though on school, and he couldn't even go close to girls, and he was like so concentrated on working and, you know, like doing stuff, and he went to Harvard. Imagine, you go to Harvard. Yeah. They say there are no like pretty women there. Like, that's what they say. Marami maganda doon. Sabi nila, it's rarely you see a pretty girl there. So he was telling me that, you know, it was hard for him to get into the point that he would play around. So he was married, and then after that, he started playing around. And then now, finally, yun, tumigil na siya, kasi I think...
Okay, let's talk about your boyfriend real quick, because we have a lot of calls here. And I wanted to talk about your love life a little bit later in the show when, you know, after we've answered all these calls. But since we've brought it up, it might be the best time now. Okay. You're marrying a congressman, right?
Yeah.
Congressman of what?
Politician. Of Cagayan de Oro. He's
okay, you're... Okay, I've never met him, right?
Yeah, you have.
However, I follow you, I stalk you, girl, in the back, on Instagram. Yeah. Your boyfriend, does he own a shirt that's not Ralph Lauren?
You know what? That's one thing.
Fucking shirt's Ralph Lauren.
Yeah. Actually, he has like the same. Well, I don't know if that comes with age. He's guess his age since you stalk us.
Oh, I'm gonna say he's baby face because I can see the baby. So I'm gonna say he's a little older than he looks. He, you know, he's got that Francis M kind of look now. You know, Francis M was like well into his 40s, but it always looked kind of fairly young.
Basing on the congressman age, you can't be a congressman unless you're 35 or 34.
Okay, right. I was gonna say 38, 39, 42.
But he's 42, so he doesn't look his age. But then
he doesn't look his age.
Yeah, I think he's been around. So the thing with
but Jesus, he's 42. Enough with the pastel Ralph Lauren with the collar up. I mean, you're 42, man. Put the shit down.
And then like I put the collar down every time we're together. When we are not together, then he put it up, and then I say, "No way, you're not wearing that," because he came from the States, so he's like, "Oh, people there." I'm like, "You gotta stalk on that Tom Cruise thing, you know? It's not."
No, yeah, you gotta tell
anymore.
You gotta tell congressman to cut that shit out.
Yeah,
but you know
but
what,
it's
though,
okay, you know, it's funny.
Yeah, yeah, it's okay because it's
such
just
a character,
fashion.
You know. If you meet him, you're just gonna laugh and laugh and laugh.
Here's what my point is about this whole thing. I know your boyfriend or your fiance, congressman, was a geek because it's that behavior that kind of shows the geekness from a younger age, you know? And here's another thing why I know he's a geek, right? And this is like me, and I'm sure Ken did this too. Mm. Diana is a supermodel, right? She's fucking super hot, right? Stunning. If I was congressman, and let's be honest, okay, he's not artista looks, right? He's just probably a great guy, funny, right?
Yeah.
The moment he dates Diana, what does he do? He marries her. He proposes marriage. You know why? You know why? See, this is back to the story what we were talking about.
Exactly.
What a catch you are. What a catch. Like, putang ina, girlfriend ko Diana Menezes, tang ina, kailangan ko na ipakasal, mawawala to. So when you see a lot of politicians or geeky guys na medyo naging successful, tapos yung mga girlfriend nila, artista or model, super hot, ano ginagawa nila? Kasal na kaagad. After 3 months, 4 months, they propose. Look at your past boyfriends, Diana. The ones who are not the standard good-looking type, yeah. I bet you they were marrying you after a few months. Yung mga boyfriends mo na
that's
model,
like
artista.
Proposal, eh. So,
exactly. And all three of them have not been artista type. Diba? Medyo lahat sila, medyo may konting geeky,
pa-nerdy-nerdy. Ateneo, Konyo, or something, you know.
See?
Sorry, yeah. But
see?
That's their...
But if your boyfriend was Daniel Matsunaga, he will never propose to you, or at least it will take 10 years. Because, you know, he's super hot. He's a good-looking guy. But it's those nerdy guys now.
Daniel, we've dated before, and like that was a long, long time ago, and I don't think it would ever work. Because I'm not really into like good-looking guys. That's it.
Oh, I love you, Diana. Period. You're the best. You're the best.
It's not. I don't even care if you would propose to me, but I'm just not into like good-looking guys. So
where were you before I met those others? All right. Anyway, let's go
wait. I have to correct that because I married somebody that, for me, he looks good, but in the eyes of other people, I don't know. But he can show me. What, you know, well, of course, whenever
we understand
you
listen,
you know what I mean?
Diana, don't even, you know, no need to explain. You know why? Fine.
No,
you know, people
like we got
say,
into
okay.
this thing now. I don't like good looking guys, then I'm marrying somebody, and then he's not good looking.
No, how about listen, English is not your first language.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, you're Portuguese, Filipino, then English. So let's go with this.
Yeah.
What you're trying to say is you're not going for looks.
Exactly.
Okay? That,
yeah.
It's not the number one thing on your list.
Exactly.
However, anybody who wants to make fun of congressmen and say, but ganyan yung tsura niya, tapos si Diana sobrang hot na hot. Well, listen, you're better looking than 99.99% of the people. That's A. And B, he still wins. He still gets Diana Menezes.
But
he's still wealthy. He's still powerful. He's still young looking. He still has Ralph Lauren na collar up. Siya nga panalo dito sa mundo eh.
Actually,
why would we criticize
alam mo,
him?
For the whole closet, I open it the other day. It's all the same shirt, but
tang ina sobra.
Oh, lahat na talaga.
You gotta throw it away. You gotta throw it away. Please be a wife.
Iba. Oh, I'm being like a good fiance to him. You know, like yeah, they look the same, but we have the same style also of like, if I like one diesel pants, I'm going to buy them all like, you know, different colors and the same. But
Right, you know, makes sense.
That's just something that you know, it's your style. And I don't know, maybe that's his belief. I don't know. Let him be crazy. He's, you know, when he goes to Congress, he wears boots, as in cowboy boots. So you can that's how, yeah. And you held
dude. Pinaparading kabayo niya.
And minsan, you know what, bow tie and then cowboy boots, and we were going to sauna, and people were criticizing me, which is another topic, pala. I forgot to tell you about it. I was really mad because. I got into trouble with taxes here in the Philippines, and I don't know if people knew about it. And I paid them right after I found out about it. I paid the $3 million of penalties, and some people were still criticizing me about it. And then after that, I attended the sauna, and they didn't know that I had a boyfriend who was a congressman. And they were like, "Why is she there? She's not Filipina." And then you know what? He told me, "Just answer them. At the end of the day, you pay taxes more than any Filipinos out there. And you're more on the right to be there and aware of what the country is all about."
That's a very good point.
Which is a very good point. So do you see why do I fall in love for those kind of guys? So you see, you guys are like...
I could do that.
Go ahead, Paul, go ahead.
Listen, I got the mouth for that. I could do something like that. All right, anyway, hold on. Before we get to a commercial break, let's talk to Jay, who's 24, a lawyer, regarding that whole sex tape thing that the person called about. So if she's still listening or she's going to download this, this is going to be a great call. And then we're going to take a commercial break. Jay, 24, Quezon City, you're a lawyer, correct?
I'm not a lawyer. I just work with lawyers and, you know, reading about this stuff. That's what I do.
Okay, so tell us but see, the thing is, remember, keep in mind that the girl was calling from Dubai, that all of this is going on in Dubai, and I'm not sure if you're well-versed in the laws there, but can you please kind of give us any kind of information that would help that caller or any other person going through this?
Okay, the thing here is that this is a criminal case. Okay, so it's not going to be covered by Philippine laws, which the best thing that she can do is, well, I'm not very familiar with the laws there, but the best thing that she can do is, again, to talk to a Filipino lawyer just to make sure that she knows she's not going to be told to what happened, because it's premarital sex, right? If I'm not mistaken.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
Because their laws about sex is very strict. Okay, so the best thing that she can do is to talk to a Filipino lawyer. And because there have been a lot of cases before where women were blackmailed into marriages, or, you know, if they reject the guy, marami ng ganyang case sa Dubai. And, you know, I'm sorry, I can't hear you. I can only hear bits and pieces of what you're saying there.
No problem. We hear you clearly.
Yeah. What she can do is she can go to, there's a foundation there, Dubai Foundation for Women and Children. They handle cases like this, and they have a lot of cases like that there. And also, again, with the help of a lawyer, talk to someone from the Ministry of Interior's Social Support Department. Because they provide help for victims of blackmail.
How about going to the embassy? And again, I could be completely wrong on this. This is just me, top of my mind shit. If you're in the embassy and you talk to somebody there and you tell them that, you know, you're a Filipino citizen, another Filipino citizen is doing this to you, and you're kind of in Philippine jurisdiction. So any kind of admission or anything of that sort there on Philippine soil, they say, Dubai, it's not going to be damning for you?
Well, the thing is, it's a criminal case. If it's a criminal case, it's not going to be covered by Philippine laws. So even if she goes to the Philippine embassy, they're just going to tell her it's not within their jurisdiction.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
All right. So Philippine lawyer anyway.
Yeah, I think she can go to the Philippine embassy and maybe request for a lawyer.
That's
just
right.
For that. But they cannot really help you with filing a case criminally. Because a civil case is just for damages. But this one is a civil, it's a criminal case. So we the Philippine laws do not apply.
Okay, thanks for the call. We appreciate that very much.
Thanks.
Now, for Filipinos who are going through this, what kind of, really, really fast, what kind of laws are protecting them? I mean, say they're not in Dubai, say they're in fucking Quezon City or whatever.
Well, the best is RA 9262. That's violence against women and children. And blackmail is part of that. And as well as, you know, distribution of pornographic materials.
Fair enough. Thanks for the call. We appreciate that very much. That's all great information.
All right. Good night, good guys.
Bye-bye. Good night. Sorry, let's take one more call before the break because this person's been on a cell phone and they've been on hold for a really long time. Kuwaba naman yung cell phone bill nila. Let's go to Iko, 23 years old in Laguna. You're on line 4. And then we'll take that commercial break and come back with all the other calls.
Good evening.
Hi, Iko. Good evening. Diana Menezes here.
Thank
Dr.
Ken. Thank you for taking my call. I'm actually kind of nervous right now because I want to propose to my girlfriend who's in the States.
Oh. And you want to propose on our show?
Yeah, I thought it would be a really cool idea.
Whoa.
hold on one second. Time out. We're going to put you on hold. One sec. Yes, it's a cool idea, but I feel now responsible. Kind of like, it, what if she doesn't like it? And all of a sudden, I feel bad
it's
because it's on
fault.
Our show. Really? I know it's not her fault, but I like this. You know, I have a self-esteem issue now all of a sudden where I feel like, you know, they're going to get, if she says yes, they're going to get married. So that moment where they're going to tell the story, like their kids are going to be, daddy, how did you propose to mom? He's like, alam mo, may show, dati, good times with mo, tangin na, may mga sex tape.
Tapos na nag-guest doon, tatlong beses. Engaged.
Ginanat ko na lang, you know, around the world. You know, anyway, so where's your girlfriend right now?
This guy looks up to you a lot, Mo, and he can do it twice.
I know, but I feel pressure. Okay, so, fine, you can do it twice. Yeah, let's
go ahead. Go ahead, man.
All right, wait, where's your girlfriend?
So cool.
Where's your girlfriend?
Actually, she's in New Jersey, right?
Uy! Taga New Jersey
okay.
ako!
She's in, right here. Nagkakarabaho siya ngayon. Ano yun?
And she listening to the show right now or she's gonna download it and then mas biglang surprise na, oh my God, you here.
Oh, kasi she's really fan of your show so I would think na
what time is it there?
All right, hold on.
If
you want some background? Do you want a background song or something like that? I mean, do you want me to set it up?
It's 9 a.m. there.
yeah, but she might be at work or she might download
okay
this.
Lang, okay
yeah.
lang.
Download
Thank
to,
you.
Download.
All right, hold on. Let me get some sort of background music. And by the way, she already knows you're going to propose to her because we talked about it.
We just say, yeah, exactly.
Yeah, let me go ahead and try to at least make this somewhat romantic. I must have some sort of slow song. Parang awala, lahat ng songs ko dito medyo kabustasan. Hold on. I'm looking. What's her name?
Iko.
What's her name?
Cor Valenzuela.
Cor.
All right. Do your thing, buddy. Go.
Hi, Cor. This is really sound kind of surprising, but I'm asking if you will you marry me because I miss you and I know this has been tough because patagal na tayo hindi nagsasama rin. Konting time ba lang nandyan na rin ako so will you marry me? I love you.
Please do it, girl. Diana Menezes is here. All the way from the Philippines. I'm all go for
it. Is that the first proposal that you got in the show? Excellent.
I've done it. I've had it on the radio show a couple times. All right, cool. So how long have you guys been together?
Bravo.
nagkaka second year anniversary lang namin last January 7.
And are you sure that you're going to go there? To New Jersey?
Actually, yeah. Kasi nag-file na rin for fiancé visa na rin siya. So, we're waiting for that, yung approval ng U.S. immigration.
Fantastic. Wow. All right, buddy. Well, it looks like things are on the up and up. I hope she says yes, but it looks like she's going to say yes since there's already a petition and all of these things going on. Thanks, Iko, for using our show as a venue for something romantic for a change.
Thank you very much. I really love your show. So, thank you very much.
Good luck, huh? And Cor, try. I did, and it worked.
Yeah, but the problem also, the difference between Cor and Diana, everybody's asking Diana to marry them. She just has to pick which one. She just has to pick which one.
I proposed this stuff a while ago, so
Diana has like half a dozen wedding rings just lying around in the house, just like
I give them back, dude.
Okay, good girl. Taking a break. Back after this. Don't go away.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
I have a new best friend who's always in the know. She knows the latest shopping finds and the most popular night spots to flaunt them.
She helps me plan movie dates and my next Burkata getaway. She even helps me keep up with my guys' hobbies and gizmos, the latest bands and gigs, and what restos I have to try next. It's great having a best friend who knows everything. Meet Christine, my digital go-to girl. Log on to Christine.com and get everything a girl needs to know. Also available on iOS and Android.
What you've been missing on the factory.
Pechay.
Pechay na na.
Kumahaba ang carpet ng pechay.
She will start with the pechay.
Oo, oh,
parang gano'n. If it's ganun. Ano, kumahaba yung hair, di ba masakit?
Hindi, ginagutin ko muna ng konti. Tinitrim
kailangan,
trim muna ng konti.
Kupitan muna.
Tsaka pagka kasi yung mga p***, tsaka ano, ay pechay pala, pechay.
Pechay.
Tsaka mga p***, yun naman nakikita ko. Mga ano yan? Ang palaya ba? Ang palaya. Hindi, p*** na lang.
Ay,
p*** naman talaga eh.
Upo na lang.
Upo? Upo. Kalaki naman niya.
Ay, laki! Ano ba yan? O, diba?
Parang p*** ng kabayo. Parang p*** ng kabayo.
Lintik p*** ng kabayo!
Join your host, Carrots Nazareno, on Live Love Lols every Thursday, 7:30 to 8:30, only here on The Factory.
Yeah. I love it. No, I can say I don't like him. That's my right to say. That's not slander. Yeah.
You sure?
I don't like his behavior. Sorry. I don't like his behavior. We want to be politically correct.
At that moment.
And I don't like his shirt. I can say that. It's a purple shirt.
I don't remember.
It should be a separate charge. That, you know. Oh, here we go again. No, it was a different shade of purple.
Oh my God, this is your gruff buddy.
You want fries in that foot? I'm on a roll, baby. I'm on a roll. The joke will make sense when our guest arrives in the set. Would you like to introduce our guest?
All right. Our guest is wearing a...
Catch James Deacon and the boys on Counterflow, Wednesdays, 7:30 to 8:30, only here on The Factory.
Sabrina's Kitchen is going to be back in your kitchen.
Sabrina, we're hungry.
Okay, it's coming.
Every Saturday, 6:30 p.m. Lifestyle Network, where else?
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
I'm really enjoying tonight's program, and I want to thank not only, of course, Dr. Ken, our callers, but our guest, Daiana Menezes, who is doing a fantastic job, as she always does when she guests on this program. And Daiana, after this, you know I'll invite you over and over again because you're freaking hilarious. And and yeah, you know, you're true. You're honest,
yeah,
which we like.
Yeah.
All right, phone number 478-7954 if you want to call us, get yourself on the program. We can also get you on Skype if you are around the world at The Good Times Podcast on Skype. It is a Monday night. Hey, by the way, if you're downloading this on iTunes, do us a favor. Drop a little comment there on the reviews and ratings and stuff like that on iTunes. We really, really appreciate that. At least I appreciate that very much. Like us on Facebook as well, Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Please do all of these things because it does help us out. Even though the rankings show that we do very, very well, it's always nice to read comments, suggestions, and definitely positive reviews from the people that listen to our program and download it. All right. Anyway, so here we go. Let's get to... Well, hold on, Dan. I know that you're always kind of busy. You're very employable. I hear you were doing a movie recently and that you shot some of it here in the U.S. I mean,
yeah.
is that right?
Yeah, I just...
Can you talk about it already or is it kind of too early?
Yeah, we can because we started it and the crew just arrived yesterday here in the Philippines. So they're going to have some shots here. And the trailer is out. The title is Sketch. It's surprisingly a religious movie, but there are a lot of twists. You will see like some loving scenes, some sexual stuff, and at the same time you will see some people who are like gonna mess up with their lives because they go into drugs and stuff like that. Then we included a character who is a Filipino. And he went abroad just to, like, you know, to work and to earn for his family. But then, well, I can't tell the whole story. But it's a very interesting film, and it's a Hollywood movie. That's my first Hollywood movie. And one of the producers is from Pretty Woman, back then with right? Julia Roberts. Wow. Yeah, yeah. So it's really nice. I mean,
so when is this one coming out again? When are we going to wait for it?
By October, you can watch.
Solid.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Well, we'll definitely have you on the show again, hopefully, to promote that when it's
sure.
when it's ready to go. So, all right, let's get to some of these calls again. Phone lines are full, but you can get in as soon as a as soon as one call goes off the air. Please start calling again so you can get yourself ready to go and in line. 478-7954. Let's go to Carlo, who's 24. You've been on hold, Carlo, for about an hour and 10 minutes now. You're on line 2, so we appreciate your patience. Thank you so much, Carlo. 24, Taguig. How can we help you, bud? If you're still there. On line 2. Carlo? Carlo, line 2? Hello? He's been on hold for an hour and a half? Hello?
Oh.
Shit, I think we lost him. He says he comes after 10 thrust. And I know that, Dr. Ken, you were saying earlier on the show that you spoke to a urologist or something like that That's earlier correct. Today. Because we get this question so much, premature ejaculation, you know, what to do about it.
Yes.
What did your urologist, Dr. Buddy, say?
Well, basically, I wanted to synthesize and structure the advice that we're giving, because what we were giving were actually correct, but for them to follow it in a, in an organized way. Let's say you've already been diagnosed with premature ejaculation with a consult with a doctor, because you're gonna ask a lot of questions. How soon do you get it? Do you just get it with just stimulation, or just with sex, or with masturbation, and all those things? And if you do have it, I think they're more interested in the treatment, and you're going to structure it in three ways. One will be a psychological therapy. The next one will be a behavioral therapy. And the last one will be the medical therapy. The first one, the psychological...
All of this therapy just so your dick doesn't explode early?
Yes, yes. And it's actually the things that we're saying. The psychological therapy deals with this person relieving his anxiety. The things that you're saying, close the lights, you know, don't get too excited. And
think about your dead
stress.
Lola.
Yeah, think about your dead Lola. Yeah. And the behavioral therapy deals with the actual relationship, the partner. And it has to be in cooperation with your partner. And there are two techniques. One was mentioned, you squeeze the penis just before he's going to ejaculate, just to make the person aware.
I was never good at that advice. I never liked the squeeze your dick, right? Because, Daiana, hold on. Let me ask you. Daiana, when you've had sex with guys, right, and you see that they're going to come fast, do you see it on their face? Na medyo pumapanik na sila? Because I feel like the girls that I've been with, sobrang halata na. Like, you know, say we're doing it, wala pang 3 minutes, mukhang I'm going to come already. Parang you can see it in my face.
Good,
mukhang nagpapanik na ako. I'm like, okay, where do I go? What do I do? You can really see them pull out and take a breather, walk around the room a little bit, you know, try to get their mind off of it. What are some of the things you've noticed?
Okay, I've had my first boyfriend, the one I lost my virginity with, and I was talking about it. It took me around 5 years to first come. Can you just imagine?
Wait, what do you mean?
If you can make a girl come in 3 minutes, you're good.
No, not you. Minutes for a female,
that's fantastic.
I'm talking about us.
I mean, but
when you know how guys sometimes they come fast.
I think there's a position, right, that you guys like get more comfortable. Well, I don't know, like
there are many reasons.
Are reasons, like for example, one thing I learned about myself, and you learn it, you know, along the process, especially with your partner, if you do it over and over again, you will learn that some things that you have on your body will stimulate and make them come easily. Like, one of the things is what you mentioned at the beginning of the show, which is
what?
The Brazilian asset. So,
the asset.
You know?
That's right.
Just the way you said it. So, like, sometimes if I'm tired and I just want to please my boy, you know, like, okay, just do it. And I know where to go, like, you know, what position to get him to that he will come.
So it's, you mean the doggy style, because then he can see your butt, right?
Yes,
because
exactly, all of a sudden, like,
sexy, I'm gonna put me Daiana, and then all of a sudden, doggy style, boom, after 30 seconds. And then, that's basically what I wanted to get to is like, which ones are the positions? What do you do? Like, I'm sure sometimes you'll see your boyfriend, he's panicking because wala pang 3 minutes, nandun na siya, diba? So, yeah. I want to know what it's like for girls on the other side when they see their boyfriend panic. Because I know what it feels like for us. Like, I mean, I'm not saying I last 2 minutes every single time, but there are times, I mean, you have to admit, there are times, Ken, or guys listening, where it just, for some reason, it's super fast.
And we must look
we must look like we're fucking like, we must look like we're having a heart attack, or we must look like some sort of panic. I mean, I wonder what it's like on the other side when you're looking at me, because I'm sure your face goes like, "Tang ina na dito na."
That's why you have to attack.
That's why you have to tape it. No, I'm just
so you can watch yourself. You can watch yourself. But it's really good because you're a very kind partner, like you were saying about that.
Yeah.
And you have your insights. But I think the point of that exercise, the behavioral exercise, it is a relationship problem, because that's the reason why you're going to seek a doctor's help. It's because if it's affecting your relationship, parang it's, are you too embarrassed, or nag-aaway na kayo kasi nagagalit ka because of your frustration, or yung girl naman nagagalit dahil she won't reach her climax. But the thing is, you're training the patient, you're training them to be aware that they're ejaculating, almost ejaculating, or reaching orgasm. The next method is the stop and start method. And
that's what I do.
Yon, stop and stop. And you're not gonna let your partner orgasm until it's the fourth time already. Sabi niya, tatlo.
Yeah, but the problem is, okay, here's why that's a flawed system, all right? I can get a debate with this urologist guy, because while all of those are solid methods to last longer in bed, they all have their flaws. I'll tell you one flaw. The stop, okay, say you're having sex with your girlfriend, right? And because guys come faster generally than girls, you're about to come. So what the guy does is he pulls out, right? What if the girl's enjoying it? What if she's building up a rhythm? Masisira yung rhythm niya, para lang hindi ka, you know, you're not gonna come. It's kind of selfish on your part to do that. So I've tried that. For example, I'm you know, having sex with a girlfriend. All of a sudden, the girlfriend looks like she's really, she might be on her way to an orgasm in about 2 minutes. By the way her rhythm is going, by the way she looks, feels, sounds, whatever, you can tell. I'm not gonna last 2 more minutes. I'm only gonna last 15 more seconds. So what am I gonna do? I'm gonna pull out, and when I pull out, she has to restart again, and that's gonna take another 15 minutes, and I'm gonna take another 2 minutes to restart.
That's a very valid point that Mo made. That's why the advice is it's a relationship problem.
Exactly.
So you also have to be open with your partner, because what we're working on could benefit us in the future, like after a month of practicing this method.
But Daiana, sorry, go ahead.
One thing that you can, okay, sige, go.
No, go. We were cutting you off. Go ahead. Go,
no, because like you're asking, like if you're about to come in 15 seconds and she's about to come, you feel like in 3 minutes. So meaning you're gonna come first, right?
That's right.
And you need to please her still, but it's gonna take you a while.
Mm-mm.
Why don't you give her,
Or go down there. Yeah, we said that. There, that was an advice previously by Mo.
I completely agree. It really works.
I know, I completely agree. But Daiana, how about, okay, while oral is great, and I'm sure oral feels better than actual sex, right?
For women, sometimes.
Okay, that's what I mean for females. I'm not a female.
Unless the female is on top and she can lead.
Right, but see, that's what I was going to get to. What if the girl looks like she's having a great time? Yes, you can please her orally, but what if she's having a great time? And I'm sure a girl wants to come too, through intersex also, because it's actually intercourse.
Yeah.
I'm sure, because a girl's going to come if you give her oral sex. Yes, we know that, right? But it's great if they can come while having regular sex. And if she's about to have an orgasm with regular sex, but you're going to go first, and you cut off and you stop to take a breather so you can recharge, it's kind of an asshole move on your part as a guy. Mm. It's a little bit selfish, and you don't want the girl. Yeah, and you don't want the girl to have to restart again. Hot na siya, tapos you're gonna pull out kasi hindi mo haya. So this premature ejaculation thing can really fuck your mind up. But anyway, let's talk about it a little bit later, because again, like I said, we have so many calls tonight and we're running out of time. We only have about 30 minutes left and we got like fucking 11 calls to go. Let's start with Frank, who's 18. He's in line 4, Alabang, on a cell phone. What's going on, Frank? 18.
Hey,
welcome to the show. Daiana Menezes.
Good evening.
Hey, Frank.
How can we help you, brother?
I have a question. Like, what's more attractive for a girl? Is it like the looks of a guy? Like, let's say, for example, if you're good looking, if you have abs, if you have a good face, or the penis size, because it's this is a question that's been, you know, so perplexing for like
the
longest time.
It's hard. Frank, it's hard, and we're going to throw this question to Diana because, you know, it's really directed towards her. She's the cool female, but I'm trying to put my mind as a female. No, if you have a guy with a long penis, and then you have a guy who has a good-looking guy, but maybe not a long penis,
exactly,
why would I go with the big penis guy? Like, I'm pangit-pangit. Yeah, you have to really establish how ugly he is. If he's horrible-looking and he's got a big dick, I would rather go with small dick. Yeah, I'd rather go with small dick I'd rather go with small dick who's good looking with abs, because at least the abs I can hold, I can touch, the face I can kiss and caress, and the small penis, fine, he can give me oral or he can buy a vibrator. You know, it's easier to fix the small dick problem than have a guy who looks like a wildebeest with a horse dick. You know, I can't make out with fucked up teeth and like fucking drool. You know what I mean? If he's super ugly, I'm going to assume, well, even though we established earlier on the show that Daiana Menezes, looks is not the number one thing on her list, I'm sure kahit papano Diana, diba, the good-looking guy with the abs, kahit medyo maliit ang titi niya, is a little bit better than the guy na mukhang aswang na tangina kalaki-laki naman titi niya, diba? So it's like, which one would you go for? I'm saying the guy with the better looks is still going to get more chicks.
He's just going to go up to the sexual attraction. It's not going to get you to... Parang I can't really come when the guy just looks good, but I don't love him. So
yeah, right.
Well, that's me. Some girls can just come, you know, like they can just suffer the world. You can just fuck around, but I don't. So even if on my looks and like you know, I'm on the FHM, by the way, January, and the issue. I look like I can just come, you know, you can just fuck me around, but it's not like that. It doesn't work that way. So I've had an experience once with this guy who was good looking. He was extremely huge, which hurts. So it's not actually a good thing sometimes to be so
good. Hello, Mr. Online.
I'm sorry?
Hello?
Hello, hello.
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, go.
I have another question because, you know, what's better for the long run? Because, you know, for example, you can get attracted to looks, right? But then eventually, you're going to need something more. That's what my friend told me. But then it's a different thing
mean?
With my other friend. So I'm really confused.
So sorry, what do you mean again? Your cell phone was getting broken up a little bit. Can you do that whole thing again?
Hello, yeah.
He said we're going to look for something
what's better for the long run? Because, you like, for example, the looks, that's the first thing that you get attracted to. But then eventually, you're going to need something more, right? Like for
just gonna develop your relationship, right?
Yeah, but yeah, exactly. You see, Frank, you're 18, so your mind is really kind of focused on the physical part. You're saying, in the long run, the looks are gonna fade, so you really want that big dick. But what we're trying to say as adults, Frank, and especially Diana as an adult female, is it really doesn't matter, big dick, small dick, whatever. It's how do I connect with you? Are you a great guy? Are you funny?
All right.
Do you make me feel sexy? Do you make me feel special? Me feel kind of wanted, desired, loved. You know, all of these things play a bigger part than dick size and goatees and abs and fucking face and chiseled face. You know, all of these things right now to you make a difference because you're 18, so you want to go to the gym, make sure you fucking look good so you can bone chicks. But what you're saying, but what we're saying, especially Diana Menezes, who's fucking super incredibly hot, is don't worry about it, man. Yes, it's fine. Abs are great. That's good. Yes, a good face doesn't hurt. Yes, a nice body. But listen, I'm not going to fuck you no matter what you look like.
Yeah.
If you're not a good guy, if you're not fucking smart, if you're, you know what I mean? So while you're going to the gym and you're working out, make sure to work the personality out at the same time. Make sure to work the brain out.
For the long run. As you
that's
want,
what,
right?
Yeah, exactly. That's what we're talking. If you want to talk long run, you have to have all of that. You can't just have a big dick, and you can't just have a good face.
You're definitely gonna get laid if you look good, but you know, it's not doesn't mean you're gonna get laid for the rest of your life with the same
person.
Right.
And that look is gonna fade one day, and you're gonna end up fucking ugly chicks. But right now, you know, if you want to go ahead and spend your life with a Diana Menezes for an eternity, then you have to work out. You have to work out all the other parts of your package. Okay.
Got it.
All right, buddy. Rock on. You're welcome. Let's take a call specifically for Diana on Skype. Let's talk to John Wayne. What a fucking name, John Wayne. Welcome to the show, buddy. You have a question for Diana.
Hello.
John Wayne, on Skype.
John.
23, Quezon City. He said, I'll ask his question because he might have got disconnected. He's been on home for 30 minutes. He said, what is it about the Philippines, Daiana, that makes you want to stay in the country? I know that everybody calls you amiga because, you know, you're the friend of our country, you know, you being originally from Brazil. But what keeps you staying here for all of these years?
I think I just, I feel like I was here even in my other life, if there's such, you know, like in my past life, because
right.
I just love this country so much. I've been in other places. Sometimes I feel like leaving, of course, because of the crab mentality of the noise. We have to admit that sometimes it's
yeah, it
so
does happen.
Irritating because they misjudge you so much. But at the end of the day, napakasarap dito eh. It's so nice. I mean, people are nice. Everything is so accessible. And let's face it, you know, like even if we have a town, it's called Menezes back home. I don't want to be the daddy's girl who is going to take over his business. I want to have my own life. So I came over, I went around the world, and I stopped here. And I feel like this place is my second home. And now I'm actually applying, and I'm going to marry a Filipino guy, and I'm going to stay here. So I think...
I want to tell everyone, because Daiana, maybe you're not the type to say it because you don't want to brag about yourself. Daiana is not a model from Brazil who's looking for work in Philippines or any other country. She's comes from fucking wealth. I mean, you guys have fucking money. I mean, you get what I mean? It's not like, well, yeah, yeah. You're not going to starve. You don't need to be here to be on Eid Bulaga or whatever.
Yeah,
para lang.
True.
Mabuhay. I mean, you can easily go back. From what I know of you, because we're friends and we've been friends for a long time,
yeah.
You can go to Brazil today and you have a house.
Yeah,
and you have a big house. And you have everything you want. But you're not, I don't want to say you're a rich kid, but you certainly come from money. Mm-hmm. Your family has money. And being a celebrity or an artist or a model or whatever is really just to fulfill what you want and not some sort of financial need.
Yeah, yeah.
Correct?
Actually, it's more on, it's not even a dream. It was just like, it was a rebellious move that I did back then when I was 16. I was still on college and I wanted to, you know, tumayo lang ako sa sarili kong paa, if that's how the expression in Tagalog is. I just wanted to prove to my family that I could do it by myself. Because everybody would always
And then you
say,
come home to Brazil, you're speaking Tagalog already, and they must be like, wow, what the fuck is this?
My Portuguese sucks. Like, you know, whenever I go home, my dad is like, what? he's like, okay, go back to school, you know. Like, it's really like, for him, he wanted me to finish school in London. He wanted, you know, different things for me. This is not really what he wanted to see on myself. But when I was 19, I proved to him that I had my own car. I had 3 cars and 1 house. So he was like, whoa, how did you do that? And then I proved to him that everything he teach me along, you know, when he raised us, and I was the first child, and I'm the panganay. So, yeah, and I think it worked, you know. And not
fantastic.
Just, yeah, it's fantastic because he also worked hard to be wherever he is right now. Although, like, my family has a good background. So I don't really need to work whenever I go home. Mm. I have my own place. We have our own town. I have many branches of our business, which is the shoe business. Mo knows about it. Like, I was
That's what I like about also Daiana. It's just like, really, she doesn't need to be in the country for any kind of, you know, financial reason. Like, you know, there are a lot of people who try to, like, you know,
they
if you're a baller,
tell
for
me
example.
That, actually, some people like,
yeah,
you
I'm
know,
sure
they,
a lot of people
me.
Say that. Nandito ka lang dahil, you know, hindi ka successful sa ibang countries.
Exactly.
But like, no, listen, the girl's got money. She's come from money. She's got money. All right, let's move to calls here, Daiana, because we got a bunch ready to go. Let's try Erica, who's 20. She's on line 3. She's calling from Caloocan, and let's talk to Erica now. Erica, you're on the program with Daiana Menezes and Dr. Ken. How can we help you?
Oh my God, check it out. Wait. Stone, sorry. I just wanted to ask all of you, Jensa Show, what's your best experience with weed? I don't know. I just
smoking
assumed
weed.
That maybe Diane has tried it because she's, you know, from Brazil and shit.
Weed is not legal in Brazil. I've been to Amsterdam though, and I went to this coffee shop, and the first thing they asked me was like, how many grams do you want so that you can enter? And the thing is, if you don't buy it, you don't enter. So Mo, I don't know if you've been there.
Yeah, I go to Amsterdam every year.
So and like, you know, they have a lot, they have a lot of chicks there though, and prostitution is legal there. And then, you know, it's a fun place to be. And although I don't think marijuana is actually the worst drug you can actually try, but there's no harm on trying so that you can say if you're into it or not. So what happened?
Well, yeah, there's no harm doing it, especially in Amsterdam where it's legal.
Yeah,
you know,
so,
really a lot of the harm revolving around it, I think, is because it's illegal. It's not allowed.
So let me remove those view that, you know, like those people who think that Brazilians are liberated. No, it's not like that. Especially with my family, it bawal talaga yan. Alam mo yan. If my
maganda
dad even know that I'm talking here like that, he would kill me. No heritage. But anyway, like going back to Amsterdam, so I entered in the coffee shop and I got a it was like a brownie. I don't even know what they mixed.
Erica, you sound super stoned. I mean, it started from the beginning. What's funny because on the radio show, we had a guy call in. He was like, hey, and I'm like, how much weed have you smoked? He's like, so much. Like, I can tell if a person is high on weed. And even though I'm not a big weed smoker, I can tell. So Erica, when she called the show, she's like, hold on one second. I'm like, tangina, sabog to. And then all of a sudden, the question is about weed. So wait, let me ask you though, Erica, how often do you get high? Because you sound like you're a regular.
Since nag-start yung SEM, almost every day. Kasi 6 days a week yung pasok ko. Tapos every day I meet with these friends who are super like, smokers.
Yeah. Yeah, Erica. So, yeah, listen, baby. Listen, baby. We're not here to judge you and shit, right? I mean, it's like, well, I mean, I'm here to judge people. Like that's what I do. It's funny to judge. But listen, baby. We don't mind. I don't know about Ken here because he's a doctor, but at least I'm gonna say it, Dan and I. We probably don't mind that you smoke out every now and then and stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, you're smoking out a little bit more than the going rate, though, that we would be comfortable with.
I'd have, you know, okay pa naman yung studies ko and all that. I could handle my high.
I don't give a fuck about your studies, though. I'm talking about because okay, marijuana generally not very addictive. Like, I mean,
yeah,
you're not gonna get
addicted
quickly.
Yeah,
like, addictive. there's not a huge population of people addicted to marijuana. However, when you do get addicted to it, if you do, because it takes a certain kind of person to get addicted to marijuana.
Yeah,
it can be profound. It can be a profound addiction. So I just want you to be careful. 6 times a week is a lot, Erica.
Yeah.
Fuck, that's a lot.
Hindi pa naman ako addict. I could stop. I mean, I stopped for 3 weeks.
Erica, every fucking addict says that, and 3 weeks is not an accomplishment. That's not an accomplishment. That's an accomplishment for you.
Anyway, yeah. How did you start taking it? Because how did you start smoking?
Ako na notice yun to. Pero recently, ever for the past 5 or so months, sobrang accessible ng weed. Like parang mas accessible pa sa Yosi ngayon. Alam mo? So everyone of my friends.
Didn't know about it.
What's the weed like in the Philippines right now? Like, how good is the weed in Manila?
It's not as good as before, I think. Or maybe baka lumakas lang ako. Pero I'm kind of sure na parang marami, pero hindi siya ganun. Parang ang hirap maghanap ng potent.
O baka talaga. Immune ka na dahil
Erica,
sa,
you're addicted.
Aww.
Yeah, even no matter what kind of bullshit you tell me, I'm like, no, look, you're looking for harder shit and you're doing it 6 times a day already. I mean, six times a week, right. That's high, love. And listen, I've been to Amsterdam. You know, it's funny because,
did you try the same thing I told you? Like,
I'm Mr. Say No to Drugs,
you know?
Yeah. But let me tell you my story here. So I was in Amsterdam with an ex-girlfriend. You know her, Diana, a friend of ours.
Okay, yeah.
So I get to Amsterdam. She's like, let's smoke weed. And I'm like, I've been to Amsterdam maybe 5 times prior to that, and I've never tried it. And, you know, her and I, we're kind of new in the relationship. So, siyempre, I'm going to say yes. I don't want to look like a puss, right? I don't want to look like a fucking, you know, I'm like, and she's like, and she's a seasoned veteran when it comes to weed. So we get into the coffee shop, the cafe, and she's like, putang ina, first time niya sa Amsterdam ever. Pero alam niya lahat na, putang, oh, sige, I want this on the menu. Tapos yan, tapos pakibalot na lang yan, tapos ganyan. And then when she gets to it, dinidilaan niya yung roller.
Alam.
Ito. I'm like, putang ina, alam na mo ginagawa. So, I'm like, wow.
Laglagan time.
No, but it's legal. You're not breaking any rules,
there.
Right? It's legal there. So whatever,
actually,
right?
You're actually obliged to do it. You're obliged to buy.
I'm now. Stop na nga, eh. You're making me guilty.
No, Erica, listen. I don't want you to stop because you're not going to stop. I'm asking you to cut back a little bit, okay? Not everything.
Slow down a little bit.
You're 20 years old. You're going to look like a fucking reggae person after 6 months. You know, come on.
No, I'm not going to look like a reggae person. I have short hair. Can't have dreads.
I know, but there's also a swag. I hate using that word, but please forgive me. But there's also kind of like a swag that people with weed have, and it smells loser. If not for anything. Erica, if not for anything, all right?
Yeah.
Okay. The swag, the way that the stoners carry themselves, it screams loser. Like,
and you have
if
to look
I was,
at the long run, Din Mo. How can she
exactly.
get a job like later
That's
on,
what I was
going to
go
like,
through. The HR person knows the smoker. They know it.
Exactly.
Like if I'm HR and I could see you and I'm interviewing you, Erica, I look at you, I'm like, Done. I'm no longer hiring you. Even if you have great grades, because you're saying, oh, Mo, my grades are still naman okay.
Yeah.
You look stoner. You just don't notice it. Diba, Ken, you're a doctor. You can tell who the stoners are.
Yes. I agree with everything you're saying, Ma.
They're super easy to spot out.
Mm-mm.
Even though you think you're not addicted, even though you think it's not affecting you, and maybe it's not affecting you, it's affecting the way your eyes droop. It's the way they're affecting you stand. You're kind of like lazier and stupid.
And you're horny and you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And that makes you not employable. Okay, Erica? That's really where I want to get to.
Okay.
Because I know you guys are not violent. I mean, like, have you ever seen a stoner violent? Right?
Because I think I have anger management problems. Kaya doon ako bumabalik, I think.
Maybe you
no, Erica, I think you have a lot of other issues.
And then, you know, just get something that will calm down, you know.
I do, actually. I won't talk about it now.
There's some medicines that you can
I think Daiana brought up a great point. Go see a psychologist because obviously you're trying to mask your rage with a little bit of calming thing with weed. And at six times a week, that means you have other issues in your life that's fucking you up that you need to get checked out.
And it's so normal to go to psychologists. There's nothing wrong about, you know, go to, you know, therapies and everything.
Totally.
Everybody goes through that phase. Everybody
last year, I went 4 times a week.
Well,
okay, Erica?
See? It's so normal. It doesn't mean that you have to smoke weed, you know.
Right.
All right, baby. Thanks for the call.
Sorry
to ruin.
It's okay.
No. Don't say sorry.
I don't
say sorry.
Oh, my God.
No. We're sorry we ruined your night. Party. Chonke. All
right.
Thanks, Erica.
Bye.
All right,
thank
baby.
You.
Like, cut down. Let's go 4 times a week and then take it down to 2 and then maybe 1.
Oh, my. I'm dumbing things on sinabi ko today, ah.
Josie, you're 37. Here you go, Daiana. You're going to need help here. 37-year-old female on line 4 to need some help with some bedroom stuff. And I like this because she's kind of, I hate to say this, she's kind of our age. Josie, 37, Mandaluyo. How can we help you?
Hello. I have a sex question.
Sure.
This is for guys who loves to get blowjob but doesn't want to do oral.
That asshole.
So,
your boyfriend does this? Husband? Who is it?
Everybody.
No.
My question is how to make them do it.
So you want your boyfriend? Is it your boyfriend or your husband?
No.
Girlfriend?
Yeah.
Well, no. You just told me a girl who gives blowjobs. You have to have a blowjob. You have to have a dick. Is this your lesbian relationship or what?
No. I'm not a lesbian.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's your boyfriend?
Yes, boyfriend.
Okay. All right, okay, I got you. So I'm confused here. So your boyfriend wants a blowjob all the time, but he doesn't want to go down on your vagina.
Well,
correct?
There are times that he doesn't want to do it, but on times like that, how should a girl ask a man if she wants him to do it back to her?
Yeah, all right. I get you. You're uncomfortable. I got it, baby. Hold on. Josie, one question, and this is really the one that's going to separate why we do it and why we won't do it. Does your vagina smell bad?
I'm sorry. I can't hardly hear you.
Your hygiene with your vagina. I think that's what he means. Like, how is your hygiene when it comes to your parts?
Of course.
You
know? I always clean
my
vagina.
One thing that, at least in my culture, it's very common. Sorry, it's very particular, but we don't know you personally, but do you wax it all the way? Because sometimes it makes a difference.
Hello, sorry.
Do you wax?
Yeah, do you wax it?
Do you wax it?
Oh, yes.
As in baby skin? As in, like, no hair at all?
Yeah.
Have you asked him what does he really like?
Well, that's what he wants.
That's what he wants. So
okay, so this is what you do, right? Okay, so you're making out, right? This is how it is. And Diana, you tell me if this is the right move.
Oh.
You're making out with your boyfriend, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then he's like, babe, can I have a blow? And the moment blow comes out, you shove his head in your vagina.
Okay.
That's what I would do.
Okay.
Obviously, I'm trying to be funny, but it's not working. Sorry. Guys want to please their girlfriend, okay? Guys always want to please the girl.
If they love her, that's...
Yeah, and even... even if they don't, Diana, because they want to be remembered as a good bedroom...
No, yes. Mode. Let's not be hypocrite here. Come on.
No, I'm not...
Sex is sex. We are all humans. We are all animals. If you don't love a person, fucking is fucking. It doesn't matter. It's just a sexual act.
They're just lazy to do it.
That they are lazy, but we'll get to you in a second. I'm going to go ahead and debate with Diana here. Listen, you're right. Okay, Diana. No.
I'm going to get married to somebody who is like on his 40s already. And I know from a fact, he has been with girls, even if you talk about looks and everything. When I saw their previous pictures, they're hotter, way hotter than me, at least on my point of view. Because they look like Victoria's Secret models. I don't know, like I just said, when a person becomes powerful, you know, everything comes together with it, and it's timing also. So I was like, why me? You know, like at the end of the day.
No. But Diana, that has nothing to do. Okay, here's what I'm talking about, love. Here's what I'm talking about. If I was say I was gonna not sleep with you because you know we're friends, but let's say sleep with someone who looks just like you. And even though I don't love you yet, I say I'm just attracted to you, and we have sex. I want to make sure that you are pleased.
Why?
Yes, you know why? I'll tell you this, and here's my reason why. I want you to remember me as a great lover.
Okay.
Like even if we don't love each other, even if it's a one-night stand, Diane, if you and I had a one-night stand, I don't care if I'm not going to see you anymore. But I want to make sure at that moment, kapag nakikita mo sa TV or nakikinig ka sa podcast or radio show, ay ba si Mo, ay putang ina magaling to. Ito putang ina hayop to. You know, even if we don't love each other.
I know.
I want to be sure that I remember. It's for my own ego.
So Josie,
what do you want? What I want you to do is, I want you to tell him what you like. Like, do not give him blowjobs. Do not do anything until you say, well, I want this also. And guess what? He's going to do it because guys want to please. And I believe that this is right for 90% of guys. 90%. Maybe your boyfriend's part of the 10%, whatever. Mm-hmm. But I think 90% of the guys, if you tell them one time what you like, they're going to do that all the time.
If Diana ever
told me, Mo, alam mo, ito yung gusto ko. Gusto ko yung hinahawakan mo to. Putang hinahawakan ko yan every day for the rest of her life if we're doing it at that moment. Because I want to be able to be good in the bedroom with you.
That's right. So, with my partner, that's the same thing.
You have to tell him, babe, gusto ko to. Mm-hmm. The moment you do that, he should be able to do it forever. If he doesn't do it and he's part of the 10%, then he's an asshole.
Can I ask something, Doc? You've been married for 6 years.
Iniisip ko na tatawa ako kaya.
You've been married for 6 years, right?
Yes,
how does
yes,
it
yes.
work like when you're married already? Like, napakatagal niyo na, di ba? So, I think people who are married, like, sometimes it gets boring or like you just have to try something different. Or you just talk about it or...
You do have to talk about it and Mo is right. And you have to be open because remember you're married. But if you're newly married, you might not be able to share what you really want to do with the other person. But best thing is be honest about it. Hey, what can you do kung nagalit siya? Mag-asawa na kayo, di ba?
Pero may lalaki na talaga ayaw nila down there.
Yeah. Kaya nga may tumatawag na ganyan, ano?
Pero may problema ba yung babae?
Wala naman.
That's the thing. Listen, I think most guys...
Kailangan lang pag-usapan yan.
I think most guys don't have a problem going down on the vagina, Josie. Most guys. You know, you really have to knock out two things.
Question.
Number one, make sure your vagina doesn't
question
smell.
To you,
you really have to tell them. Yeah,
is
go
it
ahead.
True that they say... Well, I don't know. It's so personal. Is it
no,
true
go
that
ahead.
They say that ang sarap naman ng ano mo when they go down there and then they will actually say that. Are you just I'm blushing.
No,
see me on the video, but
no,
you can't.
That's a very good question. Diana, the truth, okay? No, here's the truth about
is
going
it true
down on
that
the...
you guys say that to us just
no.
to please us?
Yes, like... yes, it's true. I'll tell you this. I'll tell you why, okay? Here.
It's really masarap. Because I was like...
No, it's not masarap. It's not messed up. I'll tell you why. Listen, here's the honest truth about it. Okay, going down on a girl is not a great tasting experience. Mm-mm. There's no, you know why? You know why? There's no ice cream flavored vagina, mm-mm, right? There's no, oh, bangin ng a vagina, yeah, flavored ice cream. No, no, it's not that good where you'll find the, you'll never find it on a perfume, yes, yeah, or you'll never find it on the menu, mm-hmm, because it's not a tasty thing. You know, it doesn't taste
the same,
great.
The same goes with the dick.
That's why we, no, that's
exactly
different.
Exactly. I'm pretty sure there's no semen out there that tastes good. It's all bad. But you do it because you want to be, well, first of all, you do it maybe because you love them. You do it because it's sex, and sometimes konting masamang lasa or konting baho, fine. You do it because it feels good. You know, it feels good.
May konti lang pag... Sorry, Mo. Yeah,
so, sorry, no, when we say, for example, we go down in your vagina, we're like, wow, sarap naman to. We're not... It's not meaning it's traditional masarap na ilalagay ko sa taas ng rice, no?
Yeah.
It's ano more... Ba mo?
And it's meron, more, that's why they made,
ba, they made products. Kaya yung ano?
That's why they created products to make it
exactly
taste better, di ba?
Yeah.
I remember a caller before he liked it and he ate it even not during sex, no? In this show.
That's right.
Pero there's a slight difference between oral sex for women and men. Kasi sa men, balat lang yun, no?
Uh-oh.
So we... Of course, if before ejaculation.
May amoy pa yung balls, ha?
Pero yung sa women, may lasa na yon even before, before...
It's the inside, eh. Oh.
Correct. Oh, it's the secretion of different glands to lubricate it.
Yeah.
And those things...
It's would, not traditional tasting.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's no ice cream flavor is what we... There's no candy.
There are some... Well, me, at least, like, you know, with my fellows, the Brazilian Victoria's Secret models, I learned from them, like, buy those kissable whipped cream and, you know, whatever alternative you have and put it down there and, you know, call your guy. There's nothing wrong on, like, playing around with whatever you have and if maybe something's wrong. What's that?
Yeah. How about this, Josie? And since you're on a cell phone and I'll let you go already. Make sure to have the conversation with him. Say that this is what you want.
I'm having a hard time hearing you guys.
Yeah, don't worry. Just download this. Download it and you'll hear it clearly if you're not hearing it well because it's a cell phone. Don't worry. You're going to download it anyway. But talk to your boyfriend. Say you want him to perform oral on you. And don't do any blowjobs until you have that conversation with him. Okay? You can also incorporate like the things that Daiana and Doc Ken was saying, like whipped cream, chocolates. Even, you know what I would incorporate in my past was ice. Kahit konting yellow lang. Huwag mo naman ilagay yung yellow mismo. But, you know, have the ice in your mouth. And then when you take out the ice, perform oral sex. It's actually kind of nice feeling. You look for different sensations.
Champagne.
And different things that you can do to change it up. And it's
champagne.
A lot.
Champagne.
Yeah, champagne, whatever it may be. You can go ahead and
pineapple
just experiment with it. All right?
All right.
All right, baby. Thanks
Good
for
luck.
The call.
Thank
Good
you.
You're 37. You should be having all of this stuff ready to go. All right. Thanks, baby.
All right.
Bye-bye. Let's go to Jay, who's 24. Now, Jay was the lawyer girl we had on the program earlier, but I didn't ask her question. That was my fault, Jay. I only asked you about the legal part of the other caller, and we didn't really get your personal question, which why you were calling on the program in the first place. So let's talk to her again. She's still on hold anyway, so let's do that. You're 24 in Quezon City. Jay, thanks for being back on the show. I apologize. I didn't ask you what your question was. I only asked you about the legal stuff. Thanks for being here. Jay? Did we lose her? She has a... Okay, there we go. What's up?
Yeah, to begin with, I'm not the kind of girl who fucks around, all right? I was in a relationship with two guys before, 4 years for my first boyfriend and 2 years with my second boyfriend. The problem I had was every time I did it with them, I always felt the urge to throw up. I mean, I love them.
Wow.
Okay, yeah, I love them so much. I know they're nearing orgasm because I would feel like throwing up already. And I would when they reach orgasm. I mean, the sex was good.
The
buildup was good. But it always happened. And with my boyfriend now,
Jay, hold on. This is a great story. And I want to make sure I retell the story for everybody to understand it completely. So you had two boyfriends. So you've had two sexual partners. And each time... Sorry, go ahead.
Not at the same time.
Yeah.
I know, of course. Right. Yeah. Obviously. Mm-hmm. It's a threesome. We would say threesome if it was a threesome. All right. So you've had two sexual partners in your life, two boyfriends, and you physically sumusuka, as in vomit, throw up,
yeah,
when you are having sex with them only?
Yes. Like, I would know when they are nearing orgasm because I would feel like throwing up. And when they finish, I finish too.
You finish vomit-wise. Now, wow, yeah, that's really,
and,
really,
you know,
interesting.
When they ask
I've never
me
heard
what's
this.
Going on, and I just tell them, you know, I guess I'm just super excited that, you know, I throw up. But the truth is, I just really feel like throwing up.
That's kind of gross. I'm sorry.
I know it is. And it's embarrassing.
Yeah,
I understand.
I'm sorry, Diana, you're the best.
Oh, I have to be ready.
I'm sorry, but that's really gross.
Because, like, imagine. Like,
it is. I totally agree with you.
You know, like, if it's the other way around, if somebody's like, you know, I'm having sex with them and they're about to throw up, I'm like, oh my, I'm going to run.
Yeah, what did I do wrong, right?
But
they vomit.
Definitely,
that's awesome.
It's really something that your mind is creating.
Yeah.
And let me ask the caller, Jay. Right? Do you pleasure yourself just by yourself?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you throw up? I was young then, so not really, not really.
Yeah.
But
wait, hold on. Do you vomit? Do you vomit? Sorry, yeah. I didn't establish that. I mean, sorry, Ken. That was a very good question. Do you vomit when you're masturbating?
Exactly. That's
no.
Yon. So okay, there you go. That's exactly my point. So it's really within a relationship, and it's not really like a physiological vomit because you're reaching orgasm. It's being with a guy.
She's vomiting when the guy orgasms.
Okay, maybe. Yeah. Have you tried a girl?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so yes, have you tried sex with a girl?
No. No.
Okay.
Maybe you should try.
Wait, hold on. Time out. Diana, have you tried having sex with a girl?
Yeah, I've tried.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and it's okay.
You're so awesome. Is it okay? Cool. Well, Brazilian also or Filipino girl?
Doesn't matter.
We're not going to know. I just want to know because it.
No, no, no. Wait,
because
wait,
if it's
wait,
a Brazilian girl,
no,
then you're
no,
the
no,
best
no,
person
no,
in the whole
I
world.
Just try the plain thing. You can't really have a sex with a girl. You know, it doesn't
sure,
really work.
Sure.
Yeah. The thing is, if she can please herself without throwing up, but whenever she's fronting a guy
mm-mm.
who has a different sex
yeah.
and that thing is in front of her, maybe she feels disgust about, you know, like his
and we Clorox.
His dick or something, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
Or the way
wait,
he
okay,
does
wait,
it.
Wait, wait, wait. Let me attack this real quick here. I want to make sure that it's not a physical thing. Okay, you know, Doc, you said, do you throw up during sex? Okay, during masturbation? She said no, meaning, okay, then it's not physiological. Mm. One more aspect of the physiological I just want to knock out before we get to the whole mental part. Is there any, the positions? I just want to make sure that he's not pressing down on her, which is kind of getting her to have some sort of, maybe she has Doc, I don't know if this is a medical thing, but maybe she has a very quick
gag reflex.
Not just in her mouth, but maybe on the stomach, maybe on some parts of the pelvis that when pushed, it kind of pushes up a vomit type of feeling. Do you get what I mean? Is it only missionary? Is it only girl
I
on top?
Do
is it
the
even
same, well,
sorry, go ahead.
In every position, just as long as they're nearing orgasm, I feel that. And, you know, with my boyfriend now, it never happened.
Oh, are they okay?
Oh, oh so
yeah.
So you're healed.
With my boyfriend now, it never happened. But with my past two boyfriends, it never failed to happen.
That's awesome.
Oh, so that's
and what did they say? Okay, now that you're cured, then it's not a problem anymore. But what did they say, like, when you would vomit?
Well, they just asked me what's wrong. I just tell them, you know, maybe I'm just too excited or something.
And you're lying.
No, no,
which
is
why
that's what you're saying.
That my
but
second
what
boyfriend cheated on me.
Yeah, but what do they say? Do
yeah,
they do they go,
reaction?
Ew, shit, that's gross. Like,
well, usually I just really try my best not to throw up. But the urge is there. And usually I just run to the restroom and throw up.
Mm.
That's
right after they finish, which is really weird and
this
is really
is
embarrassing.
You make guys go crazy and think that you're previously pregnant.
No,
I'm just making a joke.
You know what's great? What's great is that it's not happening anymore with your boyfriend.
Yeah,
I was gonna say that there's obviously some psychological thing there that you might need to talk to a psychologist. Not because you're crazy, but I just wanted to make sure that there's not some sort of subconscious thing that you're thinking about that you're relating to sex. It might be something that, you know, also related to your childhood, you know, where you might have seen something at a young age that was very sexual, traumatized you, that makes you throw up. So that's where I was going to go with. However, if we've seen the problem disappear already with your current boyfriend, then fantastic. I don't think you need to see anybody about it. It's still very interesting when you think about your past, but hey, listen, that's the past. If it continues to happen again where you know, you restart it, where you're starting to vomit again with your new boyfriend, wait, do you like your new boyfriend a lot more than you liked your old ones? If you think about your state of mind when you were in those relationships?
Well, I don't know, but my first boyfriend was my best friend. My second boyfriend, you know, I think I loved him. I did. I actually introduced him to my family.
How
and
old were you? Time out. How old were you when you first had sex?
I'm sorry?
How old were you when you first had sex?
I was in college, some 18,
19. I'm thinking maybe you were a little young.
I don't know
young.
If I'm doing my math right, but
yeah. Well, no, don't worry about it. I'm trying to think. Yeah, but maybe you started early in your mind. Okay, 18, 19 is not very early. It's fine, but maybe to you weren't ready yet, and maybe there was something in your mind you weren't ready to have sex yet. So when you were doing it, it was actually just kind of it was making you throw up because you were not in the right. Again, like the first call of the show, time and place for it. And now that you're more mature at 25 or 24, whatever, how old you are, you kind of come to your own as a woman. And you've kind of identified your sexuality and all of that stuff to yourself and no longer vomiting because of it. Maybe it's just a physical manifestation of where your mind is at the time. Yeah. And now that your mind and you're ready, kind of your emotions and your sexuality is all ready to good to go, you're no longer throwing up because you're mature. And you were a little immature when you were doing it. That's really the only explanation I can put. It's just a physical manifestation of where you were at an emotional time in your life or whatever it may be like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, yeah, I agree. But your earlier point kind of hit a button too. But yeah, you're right.
All right. Well, again, it's cured, so good times. If it comes back, then call us back and let's work it out. But at least you're not vomiting on your boyfriend anymore. Do you have a gag reflex with the blowjobs though? When you give blowjobs, does it make you want to throw up because the dick's on the back of your throat?
Oh, with my first two boyfriends, I never did it with them. But with my boyfriend now, it came naturally.
See, there you go. That means you are ready now. And I think that's where we're going to find the solution is you're just more comfortable with sex these days. I mean, now that you're giving blowjobs and you have a dick literally banging your face in the back of your throat. I mean, that's a really intrusive feeling. I don't know. I've never had given a blowjob, but I can imagine that a dick down your mouth is really a super, like, it's a super connection, you know, because a penis inside you, the vagina is still kind of far from your eyes and your head, right? So, you know, imagine may distance you. But when you have when you're giving a blowjob and there's a penis like down your throat, that's about as close to a guy as you can be. So now that you're willing to do that and now that you're willing to and you're comfortable with BJs, I'm going to go ahead and assume that you weren't ready for sex back then. And that's why you were throwing up.
Yeah.
All right.
You're right.
All right. Thanks, Jay. Appreciate it.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thanks again, Jay.
You're welcome. Ken, isn't that the greatest thing about being a guy that you don't have to give BJs?
Oh, no, man. But I think for that caller, even if she's already good and not pertinent to her life, I think she still has to see a psychiatrist or psychologist just to find out. You know, even if you don't have, like, if you don't have cough right now, you don't seek a doctor's help. Pero parang dati nagkasakit ako.
I don't agree. I think she's all right. She sounds all right to me. You know,
the doctor will not give her any medication for that. Parang pag-usapan lang nila, no? Like what you said. Like for example, you were acting like the psychiatrist right there. Pero maganda yung talagang. Kasi
actually,
ako,
wanted to
alam,
know what's the X factor of this new
guy.
Niya
lang,
who doesn't make her throw up, right? Mm.
So, kasi isipin mo, baka alba in the future she'll have children and it was genetic pala na, tendencies.
That's a good.
So she'll be able.
I don't want my daughter having sex. I'm gonna tell my daughter, listen. Alam mo, genetically, no? If you have sex, you're going to throw up. You're gonna throw up all over the guy. Don't do that. That's what I would
say.
Do.
That.
She's no, but and, okay. And one more thing before we go, right? One more thing. As a guy, though, right? As guys, you know how our egos are such a huge. You know, we have such huge egos, and
we're
when it comes to sex,
our egos. Yeah.
Yeah. When it comes to sex, we want to be so badass. No.
Mm. See, I told you.
Yeah, no, but you know, it's right. It's true. I would be actually, it would be kind of cool if a girl threw up after sex. Like, you know, say I'm having sex with her and she throws up. Like, look at that. Look what I did. Look what I did to her.
Actually, it's nice when you guys, like, burp after. Burp, you know, it's burp. Like you, when you ate or you had a good massage and then, you know, like, oh my God, something's coming out. You know, it's not like, don't just go farting around. But, you know, like, burp, it's like, woo. I got it.
one last, there are a few more to go here, but they've been on hold for 2 hours, so I doubt that they're on the show. But let's just try. You know, they've been there. Tyrone, okay. Line two, you're 30 years old in Pasig. Are you still there? Tyrone? No.
Hello?
Line two, Tyrone? No. Okay, here's the one who's been on the show since the beginning, and we've never taken his call. Hold on. Tyrone? No? Okay, EJ, you're 26. This, sir, I would shake your hand if you're still on the program. You've been on hold for well over an hour and a half. Literally, like, he was one of the first callers of the show. I just didn't feel like taking him yet, and I made him hold there forever. EJ26 Las Pinas, line one. Imagine, he's been on line one since the beginning
guys,
of the program.
How are you doing?
Holy fuck, you're still there. Yeah. Round of applause,
yay!
EJ. Thank you.
So, EJ, you called, what time did you call? Before the show?
I don't know. I just saw your tweet earlier before 9:30, and I just tried calling the number.
Almost 11:30. And when you're on hold this long, what else are you doing? You're just listening, and then you just leave the phone off there? Like,
yeah, I was online, and I was catching up on the Ustream.
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir, for showing so much patience. And for being on hold that long, I really appreciate it. You have a question for Daiana, and you're the last caller.
Yeah,
you're the
first
caller to call the show, and you're the last one to get on air. So what's up?
No, my question is for Daiana.
Yes, BJ.
Let's say, you're currently with congressman, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Hello.
Yes.
Congressman.
Yeah.
Now. Yeah. Let's say, even if it's not congressman, what are the things that could possibly stop you even if you're having a good relationship with your boyfriend? What are the reasons or things that could possibly stop you from having sex with your partner?
Things that would make you stop. Okay,
yeah,
interesting.
That's a very interesting question, because it could happen regardless of his job. You know, it doesn't matter for me if he's a congressman. Mo knows that from a fact that he's been a good friend of mine. I've had
completely.
A director boyfriend, which is something completely different. And I only had like 3 boyfriends in my life. So the DJ, let's not consider as a boyfriend. That was just a dating thing.
Right.
Mo knows that. The
yes,
real
I know
boyfriends
that too.
I've had, the 3 of them, one was a lawyer. Okay, this one now is a congressman. The other one was the director. And it doesn't really matter whatever profession they are at and how much money they do have. And I don't know why you... I'm sorry. I don't know why you started with that statement. But what would make me turn off at all, it would be like kung nakakasawa siya. Or at the same time, he cannot please me and I should be the one...
Can I just stop you guys for a while? Because here's the situation. My girlfriend and I have been long. We're turning 8 years this year, and still nothing happened.
Oh, you haven't.
When you say nothing happened, you haven't had sex yet?
Yep.
Oh.
Wow. And is this a religious thing, or what's going on here?
I don't know. Sometimes. She's saying that that she's afraid of her religion and stuff like that, but
okay, you have to respect that.
That
if it's a religious thing, it's okay.
We'd get intimate, and we're already there, but we're just scared. I don't know.
Ken,
I don't know.
Saw your face, Doc.
EJ, Listen, I know it must be frustrating because you've been dating this girl since you were a teenager and you're in your mid-20s already and you haven't had sex. Maybe you had sex with someone else. Maybe you went to the mot-mot with another girl, whatever it may be. I don't know.
Yeah.
But obviously, I know that you totally want to have sex with this girl already. However, because of her religious beliefs, even if you guys are doing hand jobs and finger blasting, it's still not the same when you actually... you know, do the deed. So that's what she's kind of, that's where the stop point is. You can probably, you know, put a finger in or whatever it may be. Sorry, I know it's your girlfriend. You don't want me talking like that, but, you know, it is what
it is.
Is
she a virgin still?
Are you a virgin?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah.
You are?
Yeah.
Yeah. EJ, man, you have not.
Both of you are virgin. Like,
You're so rare, EJ. Both of you are very, very rare.
But I'm sure you can feel my frustration, Mo.
Oh, I know. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm going to get to. I want to know. First, I wanted to tell you congratulations. And then I want to tell you you're missing out.
Come on. That's...
Yeah. Congratulations. And by the way, you're missing out on a great thing.
BJ, it's not frustrating if you haven't tried. So don't feel bad about it. You know, you're both in the
same
boat. No, I mean, how can you be frustrated about something you've never done? You know what I mean?
Because we've been talking about it for 2 hours, how awesome it is, and the guy's like, it's like me dangling a steak in front of you and you're hungry, but we're telling you how delicious the steak is. Because you're a vegetarian. Because you've chosen to be vegetarian, but we're talking about how wonderful bacon is.
Exactly. Listen, I agree with you, Mo.
If I were you, 8 years together, if you're still in love with her and all of these things, why don't you guys get married? Not just so you can have sex, but I would probably just do it also anyway. You've been together long enough. You guys like each other a lot, and you haven't had sex yet. You might as well just fucking get married. I mean, you know, come on. What's stopping you?
I'm sorry. Your girlfriend must hate me by now, but if you're really craving for it, try with somebody else. You know? There's so many ways of, like,
Hold on.
It's going to be rude if...
Yeah, I love that.
She doesn't need to know, and
because of that.
If that's something that it's really bothering him, you know, from within.
Magpa-experience lang.
Oh, pang-experience lang talaga.
Para makakaalam, no?
Pero diba, para makakaalam lang siya, kasi I think it's bothering him as a person, not like in his relationship only, you know. Because 8 years, grabe. Ilang taon ka na? I'm sorry?
26.
Oh, see? I'm 25.
That's right.
I had three.
Okay.
No, I had three.
The bad thing about
Go ahead, AJ. What?
Yeah. There's been a lot of temptation, especially with work and everywhere. I can't say na I'm pangit naman talaga, but it's just... I don't know.
EJ, even the ugliest men have had sex earlier than you have. Even the beastliest men have.
Yeah.
The woolly mammoths have. But hold on 1 second. Time out. Ken, you and I, buddy, real quick. Diana, hush up there a little bit. if this guy, right? So say he takes Diana Menezes' advice, right? And say Diana introduces him to a clone of herself. Someone who looks like Diana, right? That hot. That body, Brazilian. Bam, ass. How long do you think he's going to last in the bedroom with a girl like Diana Menezes, that who looks like Diana, 26 years old, hasn't had sex in his life, and Diana introduces him to her twin sister who looks just like her, and he says, oh, sige, good. Nag-agree siya na magiging first time mo. Putang ina, gaano kabilis to si EJ?
I'll call it. It's less than a minute. Less than a minute.
That's generous.
That's generous. Pa, kaya nga.
That's so generous.
It actually happens.
Not even a minute, bro.
Yeah. So I think the moment, like the Diana clone, not you, Diana, because we respect you, you know, and then you don't fuck around. But let's say your twin clone, the moment she pulls down that, maybe not his name, it doesn't even get to the underwear part. Maybe yung shirt lang at jeans, but tapos nakikita na yung underwear na and all of that stuff on that body that Diana has. Oh my God, you're dead right there. EJ, it's over right then and there. Just as long as your penis grazes her thigh while walking towards the bed, you're going to explode.
Mahipan lang na ha.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Let's ask him, are you open to that? Like, for example, you go to Amsterdam. They have a lot of beautiful... Mo knows that. Like,
you
can
totally
choose, you know, like, they're all in the
absolutely
window, you know, just pick one of them and then just give, I think, $400 or something on euros.
I don't mind.
Oh, see?
50 euros, Diana. 400. My God, that's a little expensive for you,
no,
baby.
No, 40 euros. I'm sorry.
40. Yeah, 40. Okay, yeah.
I think 40 for 20 minutes. I can't really recall because I was really interested about seeing them doing that. And
but
I
don't sure. you think that, if you don't mind me asking, go. Don't you think that's the only reason why, don't get me wrong, why he's marrying you? Just to, you know.
No. You mean her? No. Well, listen, I said it earlier. Diana's a catch, right? And whether it be catch because of personality, catch because of her looks, catch because of her body, catch because whatever it be. I'll tell you this, Diana, okay? This is from a guy's perspective, not because you're a friend. You are a wonderful person to have because you satisfy a lot of the things we look for. Good personality, really funny, really honest, foreigner with that accent, by super sexy accent, and then of course the goddamn body and the face and Jesus, right? The whole fucking thing, right? So most guys,
and I'm low maintenance, if I was by not, the way.
if I didn't look like Daniel Matsunaga, or if I didn't look like Piolo, or any of these hunks, if I look like a normal guy, geeky guy, na biglang medyo naging successful, katulad ni Congressman, katulad sa akin, katulad ni Ken, we were gonna marry her right away. You know why? What if the opportunity passes? What if I lose my money? What if I'm no longer powerful? What if I never get a chance at Diana Menezes again? Kailangan ko ngayon i-lockdown to. By you know, offering marriage. And Diana, that's the truth. Whether Congressman wants to admit that or not, fucking Ken, you know it's true. I know it's true that's what's happening. You can look at Cheese and Hart, diba? Cheese and Hart, how long have they been together? Cheese and Hart? 2 weeks? 3 weeks?
I mean, no idea,
a few months?
Yeah.
As per what I know from my boyfriend, he was such a geek talaga. That
right, and he you can tell.
He was
but that's why very
geek guy.
But that's why
he's so shy.
Cheese. But look at what's on the news today. What's the headline on the news today? Cheese and Hart not gonna get married just yet because of the election. But there's already talk of marriage between Cheese and Hart, and they've been together 2 weeks.
And they show very much affection.
Wow.
That's an exaggeration. They've been together for six months.
Maybe. I mean, publicizing.
But what I'm saying is, when you have that kind of setup, super geeky guy, nung bata siya, nung high school student, nung college, whatever, naging successful, naging powerful, naging senator, naging congressman, whatever, tapos naging girl, yung girlfriend, super hot katulad ni Hart, who Hart is devastatingly good looking.
Yes.
You want to marry her right away. But if you're a handsome guy, model, good looks, daming girls, okay, you'll wait a few years. Yeah, you'll wait a few. Who cares? Because I can get another girl like that. But when you're a fucking grown up pangit, katulad sa amin, yung mga ugly duckling syndrome,
no, don't call it guys like that. You guys are not ugly duckling. Oh, come on.
Yeah, but no, listen.
What,
hey, Diana, listen. No, Diana.
Oh,
I'm an ugly duckling. I'm proud of it.
And my fiance and also Doc, because you guys are like including yourselves in this stereotype. It doesn't work that way, you know. Like It doesn't work that way for you. Alam mo, mas masarap mag-sex sa mga hindi guapo kesa yung mga...
Do you have any other friends that who are Brazilian that might share that same mentality that you might want to introduce me to?
I'm not sure if they have that mentality that I do, because sometimes they're after something else, or they're after money, or they're after, you know, I don't know, or they just want to be stable. But we totally lost this topic. But
okay, listen. No. We gotta go. Listen, we have to go. My point is this. Fine. I'm the first person to say that I'm not looking this. But I'm smarter than you. I'm more successful. You know what I mean? There's a lot of things we have going for ourselves, Ken. Right? You're a doctor. You know what I mean? In the end, we have a lot of things going for us right now. I'm just saying, in the past when we were in college, we don't get all the girls, but now we can. All right. Anyway, EJ, this is what I need you to do, buddy. Where were we with your girlfriend? She doesn't want to have sex with you. You have to respect the fact that she doesn't want to have sex until you guys are married. If it's a religious belief, you have to respect that. That's what you know you're going to get into that when this girl is your girlfriend. And anybody else there, Christian, Catholic, Muslim, excuse me, whatever it may be.
Sometimes
when you get in a relationship with someone who has a very strong conviction and morals regarding sexual intercourse, then you have to respect that or you get out. The fact that you haven't gotten out yet means you really like this girl, and that's good. Yes, it's frustrating to not have sex with her, but you're still in the prime of your life, and you've been together 8 years. I suggest it's time to think about what you want to do with this relationship, and either you're going to take it to the next step and get engaged, or, you know, you find out what your long-term plan is with her. But you also have to know that you're not going to put your dick anywhere until you guys solidify this relationship.
Exactly.
And take it to that next level. Okay, buddy?
Sure.
And now I exactly know why you waited on hold for an hour and 50 minutes. You've been waiting 8 years for some vagina. Those an hour and 45 minutes on hold is nothing for you.
Right? And he said he's waiting actually to try another vagina, which is not his girlfriend's vagina. So
he might be just saying patient guy.
Yeah, you're a patient guy. Painfully
you're
patient.
You're too patient, girl. Dude, my gosh.
Thanks for the call.
I don't know.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
All right, bye. Daiana, you're so fucking funny, man. We love you here on the show. And we love having you here on the program every single time. You have to come back, please. I know I say this to every guest, but you're funny and you make a lot of sense. You're fun. You're nice to look at. Pakapag you stream. Please come back. Yes?
Oh, it's my pleasure. Actually, I miss doing radio. Some people are tweeting me and like now they're like curious about who was the girl that I said I had a play with and
who is it?
Right. I'm not gonna let's not talk about it. Let's just not talk about it. Let's just leave it. Nakabilina, yeah.
Was it a celebrity? At least that's it. Celebrity, but
they're asking me about. I'm not gonna say it. Like,
no, don't say the name. Secret. Was it a celebrity or not? Secret. Was it a normal person or a celebrity?
You know what? I'm just gonna say something to all the girls out there. Before you get married, try everything you can, because you have to be sure that you're marrying the right person and you're having the sexual, you have to get satisfied the way it should be for everyone, because later on you might just mess up with your marriage, you know, and you might just end up fucking around. So for this latest call that we had, maybe if his girlfriend's not listening, she might hate on me now. Just try it. Even fuck around and then, you know, just try your girlfriend later on.
Yeah, just like it. Great advice. We'll wrap it up on the program after this commercial break with Daiana Menezes, our caller of the night coming up as well. Don't go away. Back after this. Good times to know the podcast.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
I have a new girl who lets me do what I love. She updates me on new star athletes to watch for and the teams that are just killing it. She helps me plan which games to catch with the guys or the next marathon we can join. She teaches me how to condition myself for sports, which cool music to work out to, and where I can go on my next adventure. A girl who loves what I love. She's Christine, my digital go-to girl. Log on to christine.com and get more out of what you love. Also available on iOS and Android.
What you've been missing on the factory.
Pechay.
Pechay na na.
Umahaba ang carpet ng pechay. She will start with the pechay. If it's
ganun.
Kung mahaba yung hair, di ba masakit?
Hindi, ginagutin ko muna ng konti. Pinitrim
kailangan
trim muna ng konti.
Ipitan muna.
Tsaka pagka kasi yung mga pechay, tsaka ano. Ay, pechay pala, pechay. Pechay. Tsaka mga yun ang mga nakikita ko. Mga ano yan. Ang palaya ba? Ang palaya. Hindi, na lang. Ay, hindi naman talaga eh.
Upo na lang.
Upo. Kalaki naman niya.
Ay, laki! Ay, ano ba yan? O, oh, di ba?
Parang tingin ng kabayo. Parang tingin ng kabayo.
Ay, tears na!
Join your host, Carrots Nazareno, on Live, Love, Lols. Every Thursday, 7:30 to 8:30. Only here on The Factory.
Yeah. I can say I don't like him. That's my right to say. That's not slander.
You sure?
I don't like his behavior. Sorry, I don't like his behavior. We want to be politically correct.
At that moment.
And I don't like his shirt. I can say that. It's a purple shirt.
I don't remember.
It should be a separate charge. That, you know. Oh, here we go again. No, it was a different shade of purple.
Oh my God, this is your girl funny.
You want fries in that foot? I'm on a roll, baby. I'm on a roll. The joke will make sense when our guest arrives in the set. Would you like to introduce our guest?
All right. Yeah. Our guest is wearing a...
Catch James Deacon and the boys on Counterflow Wednesday, 7:30 to 8:30, only here on The Factory.
Sabrina's Kitchen is going to be back in your kitchen.
Sabrina, we're hungry.
Okay, it's coming.
Every Saturday, 6:30 p.m. Lifestyle Network, where else?
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
I had fun today. I hope you did too. If you were downloading it on iTunes or, you know, on the New Media Factory website or wherever site you get our podcast, I really enjoyed tonight's program. I enjoy every night, but tonight was really good. Tomorrow, G Tanji on the show. Wednesday, I'm still confirming our Wednesday guest. We have a few lined up. Not 100% sure yet which one it's going to be, but hopefully by later in the day, I'll let you guys know. Thursday, Georgina Wilson is going to be here. Friday, wow. Sid Lucero. So that's the lineup for this week. Of course, tonight is Daiana Menezes, who did another wonderful job on the program. So thank you very much, Daiana. We appreciate it. Dr. Ken as well. It's time to find out who our caller of the night is. Before, though, Daiana, did you want to clear something up? You're getting a few tweets, people saying that you're bisexual, and you just want to make it clear that you're not bisexual.
Yeah, actually, she made a joke. It was a girl saying, ha, 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 you're a bisexual. And then I just answered her. I said, exactly for... close the mic. Yeah, exactly, because I've tried and I tested myself on that particular sexual act, then I'm pretty sure that I'm not a bisexual. So
that's how you used to confirm it.
I need a dick. I can't just be satisfied with a pussy, you know.
That's it right. Hey, listen.
So that's
what Ken
question,
said this morning.
I think that answers everything. Whoa!
Ken texted me the same line. He said the exact line, word for word. Ken texted me that earlier. Yeah,
oh my!
So I understand. That's not the first time I've heard.
I'm not a bisexual. You know, like you have to try a girl so you'll be sure that, you know, you really love a dick. And I'm pretty sure I do love one.
You're awesome. Daiana, come back often, please. And then don't forget her movie. It's still only January, but it is an international film. It's going to be coming out later part of the year. Anything else you want to plug? I think you said you were on FHM as well that you may want to throw out there.
Yeah, January issue. Marion Rivera is the cover. And then it's the 150th... They're covering the icons and also the top models. So they included the international models, and I'm one of them. And
fantastic.
So you can grab a copy. And at the same time, you can watch me at Unong Hirit and Umagang Kagaganda. Katapat sila eh, pero I mean both.
Wow. How do you do that?
Channels. I tape for them because I don't know if you're aware, but I resigned from Eat Bulaga last Holy Week.
So, that's right.
Yeah, so I've been busy doing four movies at the same time. So I've been pretty much busy. Yeah.
All right. It's great. You can follow her on Twitter as well. Daiana Menezes _. The underscore is after the last S on Daiana Menezes. You can follow me on Twitter and find out what her Twitter account is, because I've been tweeting her anyway. So you can go ahead and do that. All right. So it's time for caller of the night. I thought all the calls tonight were great. We didn't have really a bad call. There are some nights we'll have kind of a stupid call. I think all of them today were exceptional. I really liked them. Daiana, it's your duty to choose a person that you liked most, and hopefully we can go ahead and give them an iPhone 5. So who did you like most from all the calls?
Wait, let me recall the one what's her name? The one that, because that's very exotic. It's like exciting, and at the same time, it's gross, as I said.
Oh, the vomiting?
Yeah, exactly. There you go. So she's a winner, you know.
All right, let's get her on the show. Her name's Jay. She is, I believe, 24, if I wasn't mistaken, and she's from Quezon City.
Hi,
Jay.
Right?
Yes, Jay.
Hi, hello.
Congratulations, love. You're caller of the night. You've just won yourself a chance.
You know, I've never won any raffle in my life, and the only time I won 200 pesos.
Wow.
Oh, wow. Okay, well, I'm hoping the iPhone 5 comes your way. Now, the past couple days, people have been choosing box number 3. I always say put it in 1 because nobody ever chooses box number 1 or something. Or was it backwards? Mm-hmm. Something like that. And then, you know, most people go with box number 2. So it's up to you how you want to go. Do you want to keep the string going and go box number 3 as everybody has these past couple of days and winning tickets? Or do you want to go with number 2, which is kind of middle? Or do you want to go number 1 because 1 is 1? And, you know, I'm just trying to confuse you here. 1, 2, or 3. Mm-hmm. Which box do you want? One of them has an iPhone 5.
I go with box number 2.
Box number 2. Daiana Menezes, can you please open box number 2 and tell Jay what she's won? And let's keep our fingers crossed that it's an iPhone 5 because she's only won 200 bucks. Please don't throw up if you get the phone.
Should I show it first?
Yes. What is it?
It's Movie tickets.
Oh, man. Okay, wait, hold on. Time out. If I may, because I know that Diana's not rushing like other celebrities to get out the door right now. Diana, can you open the other boxes and tell us where the iPhone 5 was anyway, please?
Well, however, that's better than 200 pesos.
That's yeah, I know.
That's true. What's the number one?
The number one is... Let me see.
Boy, did we close it like tightly?
Yeah,
or?
You guys. Really
sorry, I didn't know that.
Those are also movie tickets on the number.
Okay,
one.
Then number three. So the Can you open number three? Must be the iPhone 5, obviously.
An
then
iPhone 5.
Oh, shit! It was number three. See, I sneaky. That's why I said, you know, people have been picking number three over and over because I wanted to scare you away from that. Sorry, Jay. We appreciate your phone call, though.
You're
and I hope you can. Yeah, I hope you can call back again if you have anything else. And thank you for the legal advice that you gave, also. But you gave two great calls today. We appreciate it very much.
Wow! Thank you so much. It was nice listening to you guys.
Okay. All right, it was nice having you. Thanks. Have a good day. Have a good night. Bye-bye. Diana, again, thank you so much for being here. Dr. Ken, we'll see you tomorrow with G Tanji. And we will see Diana hopefully on the podcast at least a few more times before the year ends. Please.
Of course.
I hope you have fun.
All right.
All right, guys. Fantastic. Thanks for all the calls and thanks for all the downloads. Don't forget again to make sure to put a little review or rate us on iTunes. If you download us on iTunes, I'd appreciate that very, very much. And like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. It's a GTWM podcast. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great night. Bye.
Good Times with Mo, the podcast, was executively produced by Mohan Gumata, engineered by Miguel Alfindo, and operated by Icon Media Inc.
Special thanks to Magic 89.9. You can follow Mo on Twitter at www.twitter.com/DJMoTwister.
Email him at goodtimeswithmopodcast@rocketmail.com.